Forgive her. freeze! You are
Hyper Combo KO! No! Player one wins!
I expected you to be a more worthwhile adversary.
It's do or die! Fight!
Alright. Welcome stream to East Coast Throwdown. This is Marvel Top 8.
Oh yeah.
We got a lot of interesting characters up in here, up in this Top 8.
A lot of actual interesting characters. Like we have two returning up and coming Top 8 people that made, I forgot what major, was it Defending Earth?
Summer Jam.
Summer Jam, yeah, they both made Top 8 and they're returning. Right. We have No Life and Full Screen back at it.
Right. Some new faces to the Top 8, but then also some familiar ones as well.
Oh yeah, Janet is the newest one into Top 8 from what I've seen.
All right, so on the winner's side.
Winner's side, we have.
We've got No Life.
No Life.
Who's entering as This Is For Larry. So for those of you who are wondering on Event Hubs, who was This Is For Larry, it is No Life.
It is No Life.
TG No Life.
I don't understand what it was. I think it must have been something personal, but it's definitely him. And he will be playing against Ray Ray.
Yes, and he actually sent Cosmos into losers.
He did.
Yeah, and so No Life has definitely been stepping his game up.
It'll be him against Ray Ray.
That's right. Also in the winner's side, we have Flux.
Flux and who's on the other side of winners? I'm trying to remember. Punisher,
that's right.
All
right.
Punisher will be playing against Flux.
So we've got an all New York winner side. I mean, there's something in the water in New
York. House of Chaos.
All right, there we go.
And then losers, from what I'm trying to remember the order of the
pools. Losers, we have Cosmos.
What pool is that one? That one's No Life pool, right?
Right, that is correct, yes.
Cosmos and what will be the next one?
We have Cosmos, we have Moons, we have Full Screen, and then we also have
Janitor,
that's right. So. Looks like on the winner side, we're going to have No Life versus Ray Ray.
And Flux versus
Flux
Punisher.
Versus Punisher. And then on the loser side, it's going to be Cosmos versus Janitor and Full Screen versus Moons.
Yep.
So that's your top eight. Moons making a huge comeback.
Wait. No. We did read it wrong. I'm sorry. I apologize for the break. We have Cosmos versus Moons and Full Screen versus Janitor.
Okay. So Cosmos versus Moons and Full Screen versus Janitor.
Oh, yeah. Definitely that's how it is.
Great players can always pick up the game and come back into it, and that's what you see here with Moons in the top eight. Janitor, very, very big surprise out of Philly.
Oh, yeah. He beat you to get out of there, right?
He did beat me to get out. Mag Doom Virgil got Virgiled out twice, but that's okay.
It happens. It is Virgil. I mean, like, there's things that people can outplay and then things just go wrong and there's things that goes right, but Virgil, you can never go wrong with him. Anything you do is good with him.
Yeah, that's right. That's
anything.
Right.
Anything. And you make a mistake, go safe. It's a sword, it's a devil trigger. I need to pick up that character.
Well, you know, just some people just don't like the things that he does for the game, so they choose not to play him.
Oh, yeah. I think it's the holding the button for the round trip. That's why certain people don't like to play Zero.
Yeah. So we're just running casts right now. We're waiting for the final confirmation to start the brackets.
What time is it anyways?
Yeah.
I'm losing track of time. What is it?
It's quarter after 12.
After 12, so we'll be getting started up pretty soon.
Give it like, what, five, 10 minutes? Or do you want to just get
They just said that there was an issue with Challenge this morning, and they were trying to make a correction for
the
brackets.
Right, that's right.
There could be like a name change or something like that. I don't know what you were saying.
Definitely. So we'll just give it some more time, and then we'll check it out. So for
in
now,
the,
we'll just
in the meantime, tweet it out, share it, Facebook, Marvel Top 8 at ECT is going to be starting up soon. We want to see the stream viewers.
All right, so remember, yo, twitch.tv/combatnetwork. This is where we are.
Yeah. What's going on, Walrus? I see you in the chat. How's it going?
Yeah,
shout outs to Walrus, great Philly player, Tron Madness. Alright.
Shout outs to Remora just because I just see the name and it's a cool name.
Escalante, I definitely see you. Alright. Shout outs to Escalante.
You should have been here, Escalante. We miss you, man.
Absolutely.
Well, he was here, but he had to leave.
Oh, I see Ryan Golfin in the chat. Shout outs to Ryan, Philly. Great Philly player.
And shout outs to Wolf Summer. You know, that man's number one fan to like a bunch of Marvel players. He has a lot of favorites. Iron God. You're my hero. You're always going to be my hero. Shout out to you for what you did to Ray with Thor.
That's right, man.
Oh, man.
I mean, what's really cool about Marvel nowadays is that because, you know, you've got just the top people who are playing and with it, every tournament's going to feel very different. Every tournament's going to have crazy results.
Oh, yeah. And then you have such
unexpected people coming out. And that's what you see here.
Oh, yeah. And it's good that you have such good players with such hidden talent that, you know what, hey, if they can make top eight, they're motivating other people to play their stuff and then hit their stuff. Hey, like, you can do this too. Hey, Scammy plays Team Resident Evil. Let's do this. Or
absolutely.
Or I heard Justice is playing Captain America, Phoenix Wright, and Strange. If he can do that, I can do this. Or Jesse's playing his wacky stuff. Like, you know, let's do it. And now you got such hidden stuff coming out. You got Tron players performing well, Thor players performing well. You don't see things. Wow, nice crouching low. Just
people,
do it.
People are finding ways to hide characters' mistakes in this game. And to maximize their potential. And that's what you see now with someone like an Ironheart Justice who finally has turned Phoenix Wright into a scary character once he's established.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's because of stuff like that. Besides, it wasn't just him, too. There's a player, Aeonian, there you go, from Canada. I got to learn with all this stuff. I didn't know how broken Phoenix Wright is with paperwork.
Oh yeah.
That move is actually really good. It's projectile that goes through a bunch of stuff. He takes away shotgun.
Right. If you're on the ground and he calls super, you have to take an unblockable.
Yeah.
I mean, so
you literally can't push block Maya. Maya's literally in her own character as a projectile.
Yeah.
So Phoenix Wright is able to go in and he gets a full unblockable by himself.
Yeah. Taz, I see you in the stream. Top 8 has not started yet. They're just running casuals right now. Ray did play Ryu.
Oh, yeah, he literally entered the entire pool.
Yeah, Wolf Sama X. Ray did play Ryu and got out in winners just playing his old Ryu team.
Yep.
Which is sick in and of itself because no one has really played a Ryu since, like, 2012.
I don't know if he's going to stick to Ryu this top 8 because he got to play No Life first. And I don't know if he wants to risk
playing. No, I think he's going to go play his regular Mag Doom Central team.
Yeah. We don't want to risk playing Ryu with zero, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, absolutely.
Character
unfamiliarity can only take you so far.
Yeah, shout out to Task for giving us shout outs to love.
Let's just do, a run through the sponsors to start.
All right,
so.
So, okay, we'll start out with G Fuel, of course.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Shout outs to G Fuel, the official energy drink of ECT and Esports. They're a healthy alternative to sugar-loaded canned energy drinks, and you get 40% off your order this weekend with code ECT at checkout. So please show them some love. It's definitely similar to Gatorade, but it will wake you up. Very tasty, too.
And we've got Maturino, also a sponsor for the event. You want to crowdfund your favorite events or players? You want to support the community? You can start a bounty today. On Maturino, you can donate to prize pools, buy awesome rewards, register for tournaments, and even collect payouts. So think of it like PayPal and Venmo for the fighting game community. Go to Maturino.com now and contribute to the ECCT campaign and help reach our $5,000 goal, which I believe was just met, actually.
Yeah, and I think it's still climbing right now. So
we do have 5,208. Thanks to all who was able to support and support Maturino and get your pay on today.
Definitely. Well, right now, we also got Vertigear, right? Yeah, Vertigear. Shout outs to Vertigear. You guys are awesome. They're the official chair sponsors of ECT, providing us with all these great seats for the stream. Look at these seats. Car seats, they're so man, there's besides that they're comfortable and they're entertaining, like just sit on, relax, you get your game on, you don't have to worry about like slouching off or anything. You can literally elevate your gaming experience and the comfort and style with Vertigear's racing series. Pick up your own for 10% off this weekend with the code ECT2016 at checkout.
And we have 8ARC, you all know who 8ARC is, maker of fine quality joystick and joystick products. If you're looking for a new stick, 8ARC's got a new drone and carbon products. Ooh. Looking dirty right there with the all black everything. If you're tired of carrying your stick around, you can also pick up their backpack as well. Lots of space for water bottles and a stick. Carry it on your back. Very nice. Enter code ECT2016 at checkout for $10 off of any item. Go ahead and support 8ARC.
It make me want to get me a stick myself. Like, absolutely. I'm kind of interested in getting that because I need
to
learn.
And you're a pad player and you know it. All right, here we go.
Oh, yeah. I can just get my plinking up. And shout outs to PvP Live. Those guys are always awesome. When I mean they're awesome, they're awesome. They're always providing play-by-play stuff, the news. I would say they're our version of the ESPN stuff, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, they're always providing the news, the scores, and the highlights for everything esports related. Download their mobile app today and get the freshest FGC news directly on your phone. Up to that.
All right, I believe we are ready to start. Here we go.
Who do we got?
All right, on the player one side.
Oh no, I think they're still warming up.
Oh, they're still warming up?
Still no tournament.
No, this is it. This is it. Ray Punisher. First round.
They are first round. Yeah. It's updated?
Yeah, it's updated. All right, player one side. Here we go.
All right, so player one side, we got Ray with his team Magneto, Dr. Doom, Sentinel versus Punisher, MODOK, Rocket Raccoon.
He's
playing Strider, no Hawkeye.
Yeah, no Hawkeye. He's made the switch now. He really believes that Strider is going to be the better anchor and also going to help MODOK and Raccoon be a little more cheap.
Oh, yeah, so here we go.
And look at that, and he gets the hit. And this is, it's going to be interesting to see whether he chooses to jam or kill. He probably will kill.
Oh, yeah, he's definitely going for the kill. Magneto's a problem to deal with.
Limit first.
And Magneto's going down. The headbutt tackles for the death.
MODOK fights both of these characters really well. Ray's going to have a really tough time getting out of the corner.
The bomb's still connected. That was amazing. I like how he kept it all still just to keep it in check so that he doesn't go crazy. And
gets the reset with the unblockable, and ooh, this is going to be really hard for Sentinel.
Oh, watch the hard drive.
He's got the shield up, yep. Punisher backing away, recognizing he does not have to overcommit.
Yeah, this is definitely looking in Punisher's favor. As long as he has the shield there and he's staying full screen, he doesn't have to worry about Ray doing any sort of crazy confirms or overhead the distance stuff like that.
All right,
that.
Now, Scambi, as someone who's picking up Sentinel, how would you get in on this team?
That's actually the hard part. I'm trying to discover that myself, but I would just keep dashing in and back dashing just to, like, bait the assist calls. And then when I hear the assist, see that I have X-Factor, I'll punish the assist. Like, just for random calls. Let's say if I hear Strider, I would immediately do Air Raid. Just to, like, punish Strider.
Oh, yeah. This is going to be a game one goes to Punisher.
Oh, yeah. That was a struggle for Ray Ray. MODOK gave him all the work. He couldn't get in, couldn't move. It was just hands down smart plays by Punisher.
Look at that dash. All right, start game two. Punisher wants to establish a full screen game. And there we go. Here we go. He's got the shield up.
Wow. Punisher's Strider calls are amazing. Yo, he's catching them on point every time. It's not like he's just calling it a call. He's just getting it every time, except for that time. That time he's like, you know, I'm going
to do it. So the name of the game is Ray has to keep things mid-screen until he can make Punisher block, and then...
That was a good option select. He was just trying to backdash out of there.
All right.
Magneto's going down, all the way down.
Yep, he's going to kill again. Very, very solid play from Punisher.
All right, Dr. Doom, I want to know what he's going to do. Alright, did he want that? Oh, he got the hit anyways. Good stuff. With the logs, the full screen distance.
Wow. Oh, cross
Strider,
up.
Strider's such a good switch. Oh,
jamming
the jam.
Bomb. Couldn't kill.
He's
going to go for reset.
Ray's going to have to remember that his character's jammed. Is he going to raw tag in just to, like, deal with it, or is he going to... I don't think he wants to lose Doom. Alright, this is going to be rough, man.
You see how hard it is for Ray to even get established here.
Yeah.
He's just sitting there, jump back, he's trying to find an opportunity.
All right, yeah, he got it. He remembered the input reverse. I liked it. He's doing everything jammed just to remember that what's going on. All right, the jamming's gone, so he's back to normal.
Yep, he's got to keep him at full screen away. And now Ray's got, he's got 1 meter to work with here.
And
1 meter to snipe.
He's still got X Factor.
Whoa! Over
right
the shield. With the scoop. Oh, now it's Ray's turn to be oppressive.
And MODOK is dead.
Oh, no. All right, get ready to block 15 different things right now.
I like how he kept the
oh,
simple
no, that
on
was
Raccoon.
Very, kind of a dry incoming.
Yeah, is this because Raccoon is so small, he didn't want to risk, like, a whiff and getting punished for it. All right, good X-Factor. He's getting rid of the small
still
character.
Still gets a hit.
I was pretty delayed. I thought it was going to drop.
Christy, yes, this is the first match of the pool. I see you in the chat. Shouts to Christy. And, oh, Strider's getting the party started. Now, Punisher Strider is new, so he's going to... Let's see how
oh,
much...
I like,
much
I like
how
he's... Dang! He's keeping Strider at bay. He doesn't want to get caught with no Ouroboros stuff.
Not at all. Oh,
and he got
gets
the hit.
Clipped from the hard drive.
But Ouroboros is over. X-Factor is halfway done. Wow.
It's definitely still possible. Oh no, drops the combo.
Drops. He can't make these drops. Wow.
Gets a happy birthday.
Wow, don't let Sentinel die. Dr. Doom is bleeding.
Oh no.
All right, this is going to be rough for Ray.
No.
He's bleeding.
Terrible, he has no health to work with.
Time is against him too. Oh, that was scary.
Does not need to go
and he
in.
Got the hit.
Does not need to go in.
Oh my gosh, this is scary.
Oh, gets him with the jump light.
That was a bad drop from Ray right there. 2-0 right now in Punisher's favor. This is very scary. How's he gonna head?
Oh, the
wow!
Log.
The log off the headbutt.
Oh my gosh. Oh no, drops the combo.
No, I think he wanted to reset. I didn't think he wanted to like.
He wanted to reset?
Because he doesn't have too much to work with in terms of the head knowledge on MODOK, so he wanted to like work with jamming stuff or maybe like heavier brain stuff or get a bigger.
He's gotta
shield.
Pick up more IQ.
Yeah, need that brain knowledge. Well, definitely, Magneto's going to give him that brain knowledge with that overhead.
this is where Punisher doesn't not want to be with Ray. He does not want a close-up fight.
Oh, this is going to hurt, man. He's got to hold all this. Waste no time. Get MODOK out the way. Magneto's coming back in.
Oh, no.
He's not.
No. Not enough time.
Whoa! That was ridiculous.
And actually, that raccoon's body actually hurt him in that situation.
Yeah.
Actually hurt him in that situation.
Because he got the full whiff.
That's right. It made that mix-up a lot harder to block.
That was amazing how he got to grab Dr. Doom out of foot dive like that from the distance he was.
Oh, no.
I didn't think he wanted that. He must have forgot Modok does.
He wants Sentinel. He wants a Siscon. And he's going to X-Factor to get rid of Drones.
He doesn't want the assist. The
he
assist is definitely keeping him still.
Drones has been in the last three or four EVOs now, EVO Grand Finals. So
oh, yeah.
I totally understand.
And
a lot of people have a hard time blocking that
man.
Assist.
We got two traps. He's going to fly.
Oh, cross-up. Ray blocked it, but still gets hit.
Name more traps.
Oh, and it's all down to Dr. Doom.
Ooh, dang, that hurt.
Ray's going to be going and sent to losers.
Yep.
He's sent to losers. Punisher moves on.
Good game by Punisher. I like how he used the traps as a fear factor to make him think a cross-up's going to happen, and he just stuck it to the same side stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, trying to be able to get in on this team, which is so zone heavy. I mean, Punisher did a great job keeping Ray out.
Oh, yeah. Right now, we got the next side of winners. We got Flux versus No Life.
TG, this is for Larry.
This is for Larry. That's
we don't,
the team
we don't, I don't
he's
know who Larry me. Is, but apparently he wanted to shout him out for this tournament.
Should we keep him under This Is For Larry or put him?
Oh,
this is Granddad. All right, so we're going to keep it for him. This is for
Absolutely.
Larry.
Absolutely. This is for Larry. This
TG,
is for Larry.
This is for Larry. Oh, he's in the hospital. He's fighting for him, man.
He's fighting
That's
in the hospital.
Love.
So this tournament is for Larry, and No Life has been doing a lot of work.
Yeah.
He sent Cosmos
he
into
sent
losers.
Cosmos into losers.
Absolutely.
3-1 was the score.
3-1. Absolutely.
The motivation behind that. Oh my god.
Definitely. He's got his bae here to support him as well.
Yeah.
This is a big tournament for No Life.
Yeah, and to make it out of his pools, he beat Chris D.
Absolutely.
Was it also 3-1 or 3-2, somewhere around there?
It was 3-2. It was
3-2. Yeah, it was close, but
shouts to
the
Chris
last
D.
game was definitely holding it down.
Let me see here.
PS4 stick.
Go for broke.
I don't see one.
Absolutely. Okay, well, right now we're going to get into
Is this it behind me?
ZMC Mirror. All right.
He's going to get the warm-up button checked.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I don't even see the stick around here, bro. You left it here?
There's a little bit of drama behind this match. Last night, Flux was saying how No Life was his son. And basically, in essence, saying that he was his daddy, that he owns him, that he owns No Life.
Oh, yeah.
Although No Life has been in Flux in tournament before. And so it has happened before at a Go For Broke event in Philadelphia.
Oh, yeah,
No
yeah.
Life was able to take out Flux one of these tournaments. So it'll be really to see what goes on here.
I mean, it's, you know, Flux has gotten plenty more games over No Life, but here we go. They're getting into it.
They're getting into it right now. Here we go.
Flux is player one. This is for Larry, player two, purple colors. And this is how Flux starts. Happy birthday.
Yeah.
And there goes. Would you want to call them the heart of the ZMC?
The heart of the Zero team? Dante?
Yeah, Zero and Jam Session. Oh, Zero's alive.
A lot of the shenanigans on incoming go away once Dante's away.
Yeah.
But Zero is kept alive here.
But then again, you know, No Life is always playing anchor Virgil while Flux plays anchor Dante, because it's always good to have Virgil with Jam Session. But either way, the heart of the team is gone of what keeps the composure together. Jam Session is what constructs it to me.
Right.
At least in my opinion.
No Life chooses to keep Virgil in.
Alright, Flux doing so again to keep Virgil at bay.
Oh, he just wants to nut him out.
Wow.
Flux says, I'm having none of that.
Forward heavy.
I don't want your random dimension slash cross-ups. None of that.
Forward heavy held him still. Virgil's going down. You know how Flux pay them kind of instant bills.
Good awareness by Flux. No Life is really, really... Now got to make it all happen.
Ooh. Was that a cross-up? I couldn't even tell.
Same side?
All right.
And that's the scary part when Dante is called. You really do have to just guess.
Well, there's a question I wanted to ask for when Flux did that forward heavy on Virgil. He had Buster there at the same time. Was Buster going to beat out the Super?
I don't think so. No. Depends on the cross-up situation. All right, here we go. Game two. No Life Troops in the back up a little bit now.
Oh, wow! Great. We saw Lightning. I literally thought Lightning was going to crawl across. I thought No Life had that, but wow, who knew he was going up? What a read.
Yeah, one drop combo leads to No Life getting his shine on. Oh, and he drops his combo.
That's the commentator's curse. You brought it upon him. Talking about drop combos and everything. And Dante's getting punished.
Do it for Larry. Do it for Larry.
Do it for Larry, man.
Do it for Larry.
Oh, Flux is keeping it still, but Zero's about to go down.
Now, a lot of swinging going on right now, a lot of sword swinging.
But then again, Flux is known for Pixel Zero comebacks. Even with a full team, Pixel Zero is putting in the damage.
He
got shot in his face. Oh, he kept it simple.
The flocker,
we just do it. Just keep it simple.
Just do it.
You have Buster, and Buster's what's going to make you get scared.
Yep.
Virgil's going down here. Can we believe in this?
Oh, yeah. This is 9-5.
Oh, yeah. All right, good same side. Oh, grab. This is it. This is No Life's game if he keeps it still. Because this is his first game.
Flex is laughing it off right now.
This is his first game. He only had one warm-up game, so I wouldn't know. He's got to keep it still.
Flex is laughing it off. He was like, that's my throw mix-up.
Yeah, he got it. All right. So that's 1-1. Good stuff by No Life. Lightning loops for days. This is what we're going to see. Mirrors. Both Zeros are taking it. Either Flux Zero takes it or No Life Zero takes it. There will be no dropping it down to anchor characters. It's just Zero winning it.
No Life is looking really good right now. He's doing it for his father and grandfather in the hospital. Sometimes fighting, when you fight with that elevated purpose, you know, you're reminded why you play the game, you know? Reminded why you're doing what you're doing.
Yeah, that's some motivation that most players need to keep in touch. Like, you know, all your nerves go away because you have, like, something devoted you're fighting for. Oh,
right,
man.
Yeah, real establishing neutral right now.
I like how No Life is going in and then backdashing just to see what would happen.
Well, he's got the bar. It'll be interesting to see if he goes into Sogen move.
I kind of like it if No Life was to, as he's doing the backdashes, to bait out the assist and start punching the assist ball.
Both of them have 1 meter now. And No Life says, all right, it's time to play. Time to be oppressive.
Yeah, but Flux escapes. So Gemu went to waste on that one. Flux definitely escaped and kept his composure there.
Good evasion. And now Flux's turn. Here we go. This is the meta really right now. I mean, it's more than just playing Zero. It's playing
Sogenmu
Zero.
And here comes the incoming. Good
Very
block.
Nice block. Still gets clipped by the cross up.
And
back in the corner.
Big sides. Good stuff by Flux. And what's the incoming?
Does not want to get Virgiled out.
Ooh, wow, you saw how fast that was?
Nice. Sometimes push blocking that assist, you know, it puts you in an even worse situation.
Oh, yeah.
Because now you have to guess the 50-50 zero game.
I feel like he should have left it as the auto block when he already got the first guess.
Oh.
Good double jump out of it, but yeah, he's definitely taking this one to the face. Game 2's going to Flux as long as he don't drop this.
Oh, yeah, he's got it.
Yeah, we're just giving it to him. We got this? Yeah. Flux got this. Finish it off with Skittles. Made Dante taste that rainbow, right?
Yeah. Oh,
man. Bro, the characters like to take a breather. Relax.
Do it for Larry. Do it for Larry,
No Life. Do it for Larry, No Life. That's what you're doing it for, man. Try to pick it up. Wow, you see the concentration on Flux. He's like, I just want to win. I'm tired of this, man. I'm going to show him why he's my son.
Yeah.
The concentrated face. All right. Game 4. Oh.
Gets the hit, but Low Life was not expecting it.
And then jam session. Oh, but we didn't confirm with the pizza cut. Oh, Flux got the grab.
It's going to be easy to confirm. And
yeah, this is a done deal.
This is not looking good.
That's that purple zero right there, man. That purple zero's going down. He dropped. Oh, and there goes the grab. He should have believed. All right, this is going to hurt. Mid-screen? Oh, my gosh. That was rough. Mid-screen cross-ups hurt a lot more than them corner cross-ups.
Yep.
Oh, he hit him with the same stuff. Like, you want to do it, I can do it. Virgil's going down.
Yep. Virgil's going to go down.
The sad face. Don't let Larry go down in vain like this, No Life. Come on, No Life. You believe in the Dante? Can we believe in the Dante? Is Flux going to hit him with another ambiguous stuff? Ooh. But
nice
the Virgil, but he dropped. Oh, that's it. Yeah, the low. The up back.
No left shaking his head knowing. Yep.
And
yep.
Just like that, Flux took that so convincingly, yo.
Oh,
he
go.
Did it.
He let him go.
But he took the buster. Yeah. The double trigger was the wrong thing to do.
Player one wins.
Yeah. Huh? Oh, he wanted the level three.
All right.
Does that usually happen with some of the characters like that? Where you just get, I know it happens with Chris. You know how many times where I throw a regular grenade and I see a super?
Yep.
And then I'm like, all right, I just want to do grenade launcher, and I get a DP.
Or Dr. Doom who wants a spear flame.
And then you'll get
level
three. Oh, my gosh. That is
the
worst.
Happens all the time.
That is the worst.
All right, next up, it looks like we're
going to
have our
losers
bracket match.
Bracket.
We're going to have Janitor versus Full Screen.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Janitor from Philly, very strong player. Mag Doom, Virgil player. And Full Screen, who is, this is his second ever major, and this is his second top eight in Marvel.
Yeah, he did pretty good.
A really, really great New York player. He plays Morrigan, Doctor Strange, Doom, a team that is predicated on stealing your meter.
And he's using the Eye of Agamotto assist. Shout outs to iHeartJustice to showing that neutral with that assist. And now I guess he picked up on it on using it neutral, but originally he uses it to use it as a meter steal on the combos, right?
Right. So it serves two purposes for Full Screen. Number one, it serves as a defensive option for Morrigan, so it prevents any rushdown. Number two, if Morrigan gets any sort of clean hit and the assist is available, Morrigan can actually steal up to three bars.
Oh my gosh! That's
three bars. If he optimally does his fireball soul drain combo, it can steal up to three bars, leaving the opponent with zero meter to work with, and Morrigan with a fully stocked.
Oh,
so
man.
this is a very scary team, very defensive Morrigan. However, once Morgan's down, then that's where a lot of the comeback factor gets lost.
Yeah, and it becomes more of a, like, I got to believe in Doctor Strange.
Got to believe in Doctor Strange, and Doctor Strange's got to take a lot of incoming.
Yeah, and on top of that, like, I don't know how it's going to work. He usually likes to just go with the super and immediately burn the X-Factor just to protect him. Yeah. But anyways, we're going into the match right now.
So here we go.
Player 1, Janitor. Player 2, TG, Full Screen.
Absolutely, and I got to say, this is going to be pretty tough here now for Janitor. Because he's got to be able to fight. See? That Eye of Agamotto, when it's used defensively like that, keeps a lot of rushdown characters from coming out. He's got to just hold it. Yep.
Yeah, it's rough. Yep. It's really low. You can't jump in on that edge.
And
it's kind of hard.
All of a sudden, the chip out is real.
Oh, yeah. And it's kind of hard knowing that you can't jump in on that system. You got to, like, keep the distance and shoot it. And that's what Morgan's for, to stop you from even doing anything.
Yeah.
She keeps the distance herself. He has no meter, but what, here comes Full Screen. Ooh, good.
Very
there
nice.
Goes.
Oh, here we go. Oh, no, he messed it up. But that meter steal was coming.
It was definitely coming. Ooh, plant the feet on her chest.
I would actually like to see Full Screen kind of back away here. He does not need to really go in right now. Yeah. Yep. All right. And nope, going to get hit with the missiles.
Is Dr. Doom going down? Oh, no, he's trying to save him.
Oh, Janitor got a little greedy there.
He wants to bring in Swords to Virgil safe with the assist. He doesn't want Dr. Doom to die in vain. And he wants to make sure he has incoming set. I respect this a lot.
Oh, here we go.
It's only because he has no meter and no assist to really work with.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Full Screen was being a little greedy there when he wanted the Soul Drain kill. Oh. Just gets smacked in the face with the H.
Ooh, good rapid slash.
Full screen Doom is nothing to slouch at, but this is going to be really hard.
Yeah, he has no X Factor, but he has enough bar, but Virgil keeps getting clean hits like this. We're going to call it done. Ooh, there it goes.
It does not get the super jump.
What a fail. And
Janitor
takes
the Janitor.
Yeah, what a fail. I don't know if it's the cold fingers or... Wow. Good stuff by Janitor.
All right. Janitor was able to steal game one after Full Screen was in full control. Yep.
Oh. I know he wants to punish Morrigan, but he's got to watch out that the Sulcus is coming from behind him.
Janitor really has to snipe the assist and then find a way to rush down. That's got to be his game plan.
Oh, he wanted to kill. He wanted to kill Magneto and snap and Virgil.
All right.
But dang, this is
Let's see if it's going to be worth it. No drops a combo. Oh, gets it right back up though.
Dr. Doom's going to have to come in and take all this. Here we go. the missiles coming down. This is where full screen got his name. Now this is where we say when I met full screen before he was full screen.
Very nice.
X-Factor definitely killed him, but yeah, back to what I was saying about his name, he definitely stood safe as possible. He didn't want to go in or nothing like that.
Again, full screen overextends himself and he pays for it. Now with the incoming, that's cheap.
That's what you were talking about where Dr. Strange has to take all the incoming, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, he's got to be able to take it. And now again, Janitor has found himself despite getting Morganed out in a good position.
Even with the loss of Virgil and no X-Factor left, he still has Magneto, who found every way to get around that. Now he's going to play it safe. He doesn't have to overcommit. He has the life lead. Dr. Doom has to struggle more than anybody
else. Better zoning options as well. Yeah. Full screen now has to get in.
It's going to be hard for him to get in, knowing that he has a good jump.
Wow!
Yes! He called from that high.
Magneto's gonna go down. This is a match now.
That's what we believe in.
What a level three. What a balls to the wall, all in level three.
Oh man. I honestly didn't think that was gonna work. I mean, like when he just did it, I was like, oh no,
he's
jumped.
Did it. Just do it.
And I saw Magneto in the air. Like it wasn't gonna work. And then he got him. Oh, he showed him a love tap right in the back of the neck. You gotta watch out for those. I would have air dash and foot dive. Oh, I would have did it immediately.
He had a punish available, into foot dive in the blind slot.
But he didn't want to take it. I don't know why he didn't want to risk it.
Maybe he just didn't feel confident. Sometimes when you foot dive in that position, you get clipped by a stray laser at the very bottom.
That
does happen.
I mean, I feel like he could have air dash flight and then just foot dive.
Janitor just very content to hold on to his life lead. 10 seconds on the clock.
Full screen needs to figure out a way in there right now because time is definitely not on his side. 6 seconds left
in the
clock.
Careful. Oh!
No! For the drops!
The nerves, the jitters.
Two seconds left.
Oh, Spear Flame?
No, that's it. No. And we run down the clock.
Janitor
takes
goes
it.
Up 2-0 on
full screen. Yep.
Oh, my. Mark being in full in really good control in the match for the first two rounds, and Janitor finding a way to make full screen overcommit.
Oh man.
Getting the X Factor, killing Morgan, and then taking care of Strange. So
it was really rough. I thought he did have an opening window with that super, with the foot dive he could have did. I don't know what he was afraid. I think you were right when he was afraid about still getting clipped. But it still would have been in his favor if he got clipped. The foot dive's a hard knockdown.
Well, Mark's got to bring it all the way back now.
He's down two games. We're back at it again. I want to know what Morgan's going to do because he lost Morgan twice. That was a hard loss on those games.
Shout outs to Wedge in the chat. I see you. All right.
I like how he's doing Magnetic Blast to keep her at bay. But Mark, he definitely let Astral go to waste. See, there was no focus going on.
Duel Kevin. So on the winner's side,
now on the winner's side, we have Flux and Punisher.
Yeah, we have Flux and Punisher. Flux beat TG, This Is For Larry, a.k.a. No Life.
And Punisher beat Ray Ray.
So
they're waiting in winner's finals.
Waiting in winner's finals right now. This is the first match in losers with Janitor up 2-0 against Full Screen.
And Janitor once again taking down. That was great. He eliminated Morgan and made Strange take that.
I thought we were going to see a squeeze.
What a drop we didn't want.
No.
Is Full Screen waking back up? Look at the love taps on the palms.
This is a very strong Strange. Very strong Strange.
Oh, he's putting it right in his cheeks. The eye. Ooh. Oh, we just did it.
Just did it.
Shout outs to the Philly squad for telling him he's going to get you every time. Every time it gets you. Don't worry about
Janitor,
how it does. Just know it does.
Janitor trying to clean it up, making it a clean sweep. 3-0. It's all down to this incoming.
Is he gonna book?
He
messed it up and he got Virgil hit.
He's gonna book. Ooh, X Factor.
Ooh. Where we palm the eye. Stop.
Oh.
Wow.
Almost a great confirm.
That was an amazing confirm. If
almost
only he finished
amazing.
It.
Yeah. Oh, they're just falling out right now.
Ooh.
Good scoop.
And Janitor takes
back
full screen 3-0.
Janitor. The clean sweep.
Clean sweep
from
by
the janitor,
yo. He brought the broom on him.
Clean sweep from the janitor. 3-0.
Full screen had two opportunities in two matches, and he let it go to waste.
And full screen is eliminated from the tournament.
Janet is climbing. This is his first time, yo. Tied for fifth. Can he go further?
All right.
That broom is that broom's taken. That broom. Now next we have Cosmos versus Moons. Woo!
All right, the Vertigear chairs have been disarmed, which will give the players a little bit more elbow room, I think, here.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. That's great. That's great. Vertigear with the detachable elbow, so that way, sometimes when you know when you're playing on a stick and the side arms can actually get in the way of you playing. So it looks like they're bringing back in the Vertigear chairs without the arms, so give the players a little bit more room to get some freedom to shine. Shout-outs to Vertigear.
Oh, yeah, definitely. We're going to run some ads?
Absolutely. The official chair sponsors of ECT.
Yeah, we have time for doing that. Vertigear, you guys are mad love. You know, we appreciate the chairs you give out, the arm space, the no arm space, the fact that you created these things. Yeah. These are the official chair sponsors of ECT, providing them for three awesome chairs. All these awesome chairs.
These are the SL2000s. Very, very comfortable. You can sit back and lean back, get your shine on. Elevate your gaming experience with these chairs. If you want your own, you can pick up your own for 10% off this weekend with the code ECT2016 at checkout. This offer will be valid until September 5th.
And remember, it's 10%, man. Don't waste no time. Get those chairs. If you want one just to have at home, just so you can relax, watch a movie or game online, take one home with you. They're also mobile. They don't just plot and sit. They have wheels so they can move.
Absolutely. When they're shipped to you, easy to assemble, easy to get together, right? So, definitely support these guys for supporting the fighting game community and ECT 2016. All right, so looks like we're ready to get started here. They're resetting the score.
All
Cosmos,
right.
Again, another Morgan Deuce Virgil.
Yeah,
a little bit more aggressive play. And Moons with the tricky stuff. Nova, MODOK, and Ami.
Yeah, Cosmos part of team level grinding. So we got, is Moons still TA or is it just Moons now?
Just Moons.
He's just Moons. All right, so just we have level grinding Cosmos against just Moons.
All right.
Against Moons. Starting off Morgan against Nova.
Now Nova can actually fight Morgan midstream. He's got a couple of options. He's got one speed tackle to be able to use, and then he's also got Centurion Rush 8, which will also eat up all the fireballs. But putting both those moves out are both kind of risky, so he's got to know when to do it.
I like how Cosmos is keeping the Sophist tighter and closer that way. Ooh.
See, so there's one. He gets one shot at his speed tackle, and now he's got to play full screen and try and hopefully build up the bar again. He also does have Centurion Rest H to be able to use that in the neutral to be able to snipe, but again, it's a really risky play. If she blocks it, he's dead.
Yeah, because look how Cosmos is keeping his the door closed on him. There's no way he can get random. Oh, and he took some bar. That hurts.
This is going to be really rough.
And here we go. MODOK is too big to avoid all, so this is going to be scarier. I feel like if Moons was to, like, I see he's air dashing up with the super jump. If he was to do the headbutt to further escalate higher, he can avoid some of the missiles, and he can still avoid the Sophist. So now that when Cosmos has no bar, he can find his opening in. But he's just, like, taking it as a regular.
Yeah. This is going to be really, really hard. And Ami's going to have a really tough time with this as well.
But Ami's smaller. Ami could find her escapes out of there. Oh, I feel like he could have had the punish.
Yeah, this is going to be really tough.
Yeah, it is real tough. I don't think he can reflect the soul fist even from behind him. Cause
no, can't.
So he's going to get hit anyways. And there goes the chip.
X-Factor, yep. Now he's got to get in.
Oh.
Almost got the anti-air. Very scary now.
The overhead H.
No. Yep.
Dang, this is rough. Morgan's is running over Marvel.
Morgan.
She's the death of our game. I'm going to say that. She's the death of our game. I hate her. She's what creates the boredom. Like, yo, this is the unstoppable character.
Very, very interesting now. Okay, Moons is putting MODOK first, basically as a meter building shield so that Nova gets a couple more opportunities to snipe with Human Rocket. So that's a very interesting choice by Moons. We'll see what happens.
I'm amazed he's not chasing after him in the flight, because MODOK can actually go into flight before the fight starts. His jump is a flight.
Yeah, I don't know. With missiles and with Morgan, just in general, Shadow Blade, I mean, I honestly think Moons is just playing MODOK at the point position to give Nova some more bars.
Okay, so
the MODOK, more rap bars.
So you're saying MODOK can be the meat shield.
Right, exactly.
Got you.
Yep. See, he's saving the bar. He wants Nova to have more chances to snipe with Human Rocket.
Yeah, I like how he's using the beam to snipe out the Doom Assist. He's just waiting to see his options. Eliminating the Sophist as well.
Yeah. There you go, yep. See, he wanted that Human Rocket snipe and he missed it.
Yeah, it was a failed attempt.
Now he's got to bring it back in.
He was too far away. Yeah. He thought Morgan was a little closer. Oh, this is going to be rough. Yep. He's going to have to fall into it eventually. Oh, man.
All right. Morgan's not. Yep, there's Saturnian Rush H. He wanted Saturnian Rush H to get in, but still missed it. Gets the slot.
And there goes the hit on Morgan. Morgan's going down.
Finally was able to wait till Morgan had no meter. Good. Morgan's finally going to go down. He misses the super.
I don't know where the air dash down came down. I think he was moving too fast.
Why?
He must have been moving way too fast.
Rocket? Nope.
Dies to the chip.
Good block.
I would have X Factor right after that.
Yeah, Cosmos misses flight. That's why the S came out.
Virgil's coming in to fight the Doug. He doesn't want to risk any crazy stuff. Good grab. That was scary. I didn't know what was going to happen.
Kind of a little bit of a random X Factor there. I don't know if I like that.
Is the slowdown going to help knowing he's an X Factor?
No. Nice attempt.
I thought he was going to avoid the misses if he got the forward H.
The slowdown, though.
Stop the recovery. Virgil went down.
He needs three more hits. Three more hits. X Factor's going to be gone. Slowdown's
There's no more
help.
X Factor, so. Ooh, wow. Off screen grab.
Still needs three more clean hits. All right.
Wow, other side.
One of them. Oh reset. Hit again.
The clean hits.
Combos. Wow. All right. We've got a real fight now. What a read!
Read off the S.
Knew that he was gonna fall down with a button.
And Moons is taking this game. Wait, no, she's alive. She's alive.
One more shot.
Oh, he messed the confirm. Moons, he wanted to go
really
into sword.
Now. He's gotta be really careful now.
He wanted to go into sword and he failed.
Next hit wins.
But he got a few seconds on the clock. 4 seconds left.
No! Bad dash for Moons.
Oh, he got the hit.
The sword hit. Very, very nice. Bones leaning back in his chair.
He's catching a breather.
Very stressed out.
I would have been stressed out too. But then again, I have no choice but to be stressed. My team sucks against stuff like that.
All right, here we go.
Game 3, 1-1.
This
is how we do it, a happy birthday.
I was about to say, I like the idea of MODOK starting now because you've got Nova with more chances to snipe. You also have MODOK being able to assist punish. There you go, on the missiles right there.
Yeah, but he got hit with the overhead. And he's sniping in Ami.
Ami's a problem.
The fly, unfly,
the
below.
Moon's shaking his head.
And then he's going to take the bar behind it and then blast his dog with the missiles. Is he dead? Yep.
Yep, Shadow Blade.
Sister.
Right. But Moon's has three stocks to be able to snipe with Human Rocket.
Dang, and he's losing
two stocks.
Oh my gosh.
Yo,
it's stuff like that we didn't want to see. That hurts, yo. Wow. Cosmos is feeling untouched.
MODOK. Yep.
Oh, no. There's a chip.
Human Rocket. Very nice attempt by Moon. Gotta hold it. Human Rocket, yep.
Never mind. No perfect. We're definitely punching the Doom.
Very nice. Saw that Cosmos was throwing out the normal.
Human
Rocket will lose the physical attacks.
It's 2-1, Cosmos.
That was a bad happy birthday in the beginning. It really wrecked.
It
really wrecked Moon's ability to be able to play.
I like how Moon's just stayed up top to snipe Morgan and the assist calls while winning the Sophist.
And
Cosmos is chasing him.
There you go. Yep. Moons is really trying to snipe out Doom. Objective one. Objective two is to be able to give Nova a chance to be able to come in with more meter
the
for Human Rocket. Because that's really the only way that Morgan will get hit in this matchup.
Oh my god, Morgan has too much to work with. I can't take it anymore.
All right, two shots.
Kept the incoming simple just to keep
two
in the
rockets.
Corner.
Two rockets. Two Rocket should be able to get used that. Yep, and Cosmos recognizes that that's the only thing that he can do. So
that's right.
Ah, there it is, yep.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
What a way to go.
Cosmos is going to take it.
Yep, 3-1 Cosmos.
3-1, Boons is out of the tournament.
Player one wins.
All right. Good stuff to Moons, though.
All right. Wow.
All right,
I'm actually tired. I could use something to drink. That's definitely not mine.
Well, do you want something to drink? We have the official energy drink of
BCT
Esports.
I could use some of that to wake up. You know, like,
I'm
actually really tired. G Fuel is definitely that wake-up call I need.
A healthier alternative to sugar-loaded canned energy drinks. Get 40% off your order this weekend with the code ECT at checkout. We want to thank them for supporting the community.
Oh, yeah. They're the official energy drink of ECT and Esports. We definitely could use some of that. So this is an awesome cup. Do we have any more of these cups? Because I definitely want to take one home. Wake me up, G Fuel.
I never felt so energized in my entire life.
I hate you right now. I hate your enthusiasm because it's so like.
My promo game is too strong right now. My promo game is.
You're
too
on your flow from progressive status right now. Oh man.
That's right. That's right. All right. Well, it looks like we've got Janitor coming up.
He's picking it back up against. Who is he playing?
He's playing. This is for Larry. TG. This is for Larry, aka No Life.
Oh yeah.
In case you're wondering why No Life has chosen that name, Larry is his grandfather who's in the hospital right now. Thoughts and prayers definitely go out to Larry who's fighting right now. No Life honoring him in this tournament.
Do we actually have any G Fuel, by the way? I'm sorry for like change the subject. I actually do want to drink.
There's some somewhere, but I don't want that
exactly. How do we go from talking about something so serious to tell you?
I know it's serious, but I actually am pretty thirsty. Like. It's catching me. It's catching me.
I've seen around, but I don't know exactly who's holding the stockpile.
We're trying to honor the man's grandfather, and I'll scam you once.
I'm sorry. I need to wake up on this because it's catching me. It's catching me.
Oh, gosh. Anyways, thoughts and prayers go out to Larry for sure.
Yeah, Larry's the man, yeah.
All right, here we go. Doing a little button checking here.
I actually like that stick that Larry's, that No Life is playing with. Yo, No Life, can you do me a favor? Can you just hold your stick up into the camera? Those are the type of sticks that you need to work with, yo. Shout out to ADARC for such cool designs and models on their sticks. If you guys need some sticks, please go to those guys. Any type of stick you need, they have new drone and carbine products. So if you're tired of carrying your stick around as well, just know that they also have backpacks. You could always carry some comfortable stuff. They always fit any type of stick that you have. I think it's usually their models, right? You have a stick like that too, right?
I don't.
Oh, you just have their backpacks.
Yeah, I have a different company, which will go unnamed because we want to.
I know. We're focusing on ADARC. ADARC is.
But ADARC does make quality products. We want you to pick up the stuff.
So if you guys want $10 off any of your items, just enter the code ECT2016 at checkout for any of the items, whether it's the backpacks or the sticks.
All right.
Anyways,
here we go. Into the first match.
Into the first match. Janitor player one. This is for Larry player two. No Life's going to. Oh, never mind. He's getting hit with lows. Good blocks.
Good blocks. Oh, almost gets a happy birthday here.
And we're going straight to the So Genmu. Oh, that was a good jump off the mix-up. That was a cross-up buster, too.
Yeah.
But it didn't save him from the jam session. He couldn't escape that.
That's right. All right. Looks like Magneto's going to go down.
And No Life is snapping in for Virgil because he doesn't want to deal with it. Oh, he wanted to grab.
Wanted the throw. Wanted the grab. Still worked out, though. All right, Birch is going to get looped and he's going to go down here.
Oh, yeah. Dr. Doom's going to come in. I don't know how he's going to take this mix-up. Oh, that was a good block. I literally thought he was going to cross up, but he did the short dash special move. Just to keep it short and same-sided.
No Life recognizing that a lot of people, when they see Jam Session and Zero move in, will block cross-up. So he keeps the same side quite a bit.
Janitor took a good choice. It didn't help him on that time. He literally fully dashed all the way for the cross-up.
Looks like Janitor about to be sweet.
All right.
All down to Magneto.
Good blocks in the. Ooh. Almost hit him with the fast high low.
Gets clipped with the buster. Game one.
Going to No Life.
Really,
oh, the drop.
No.
Oh, the low.
He wanted to keep it interesting.
That is so cheap. I thought Janitor was going to take the opportunity to X Factor, but I guess he wanted to wait to see what was going to happen, and we definitely saw that he got his toes clipped.
Yep. So, I mean, again, the name of the game is
That's what we call headhunting. Oh, man.
Hey, when 70% of your moves can turn into a cross-up, that's when you know you're playing zero. Oh!
Ooh!
Again, blocker. Shoutouts to blocker.
Damn, Verge is going to take all this. Everything is going to be taken with his chest. Ah! Ah, so much lightning work. Ah!
All right.
That all is right. The most
same
electrifying
side
robot.
Same side of cross-up. Same side of cross-up.
Definitely
same
side.
Side. Yep, see? People get a little bit too flinched up when they see Dante and Zero teleport. So No Life doing a smart thing by keeping this inside.
Oh, here we go. The loops once again. The loops once again.
Oh, cross up lightning. Oh, nope. Try to go for the infinite.
I don't know. Wait. I like how he's trying to keep it safe. Oh, never mind. He has the X Factor.
Good X Factor. Recognizing that it was going to hit him.
But then again, I think Nolik was trying to take it into, like, hey, there's nothing he could do about it. But never mind. The underestimation is going to get Virgil killed. I want to know what's the mix up, because Janna is showing is not going down without a.
Wilding out a little bit too
much. That was my curse. That was the curse. I said he's not going to go down without a fight. And he takes the S. Ooh. Right now, No Life is up 2-0 over Janitor. Janitor's taking a breath right now to think about what happened. Alright, so now we're going back into it. 2-0, No Life over Janitor. Wow!
Just do it.
But it was quick.
And
he
Why
did it.
Not?
He caught him off the disruptor. It was really quick.
Why not? Just do it.
And there goes Magneto going down. Short work for No Life.
Hey, he's doing it for Larry. He's doing it for his grandfather.
Oh, wow. What a way to keep the box closed, right? You saw how he kept the corner just. Oh. Oh, man. Oh, my gosh. Janitor's looking for his opportunities. Oh, no. He won his swords. Okay. Pizza cut didn't miss. Oh, wow. What a grab.
And the confirm.
The oh, man. I want to know what's going to happen when it comes to.
And the confirm.
Oh, he snapped in. He doesn't want to deal with level 3 Virgil. But honestly, No Life should have believed in his incoming confirm. He didn't have to worry about Virgil anymore. But wow, Swords is putting in justice.
Oh no, this is scary now.
Oh man, Janitor has a lot to
work. Sword up. This is very, very scary now.
Oh, he caught it under the sword.
Underneath the sword.
And this there goes Janitor. Janitor is losing Virgil. All right, are we going to believe in the Philly tech? He's going to hit him with your foot diving no matter what. Catches you every time. Oh, no, he didn't catch him this time. Oh, wait. He literally tried to touch the
game. And Janitor is eliminated.
No Life takes it 3-0.
Tournament. Shout outs to Janitor, though. Showing Philly's back into it. All right, now, Scammy, you've got a lot of products on you right now.
There's a lot of stuff in
there
front of me.
There's a lot of products on here. All right.
For those who don't know, shout outs to G Fuel and what is this?
Yeah, this is the 8ARC drone model stick. Actually, also made 8ARC and Quamba, so same company. But Quamba makes a new drone PlayStation 3 arcade stick. Also, G Fuel drink.
Very refreshing.
Very refreshing. Only 25 calories, not a high calorie energy drink. This is a drink that you want to take if you want to lose some weight because you've been sitting, playing computer games, playing Marvel for 8 hours straight. And you don't want to get fat.
It's actually
so there you go.
Really good.
It's really good. Huh?
It's really good. It's green apple. It tastes it's refreshing.
There you go.
Wow.
There you go. So go ahead and support these products.
You already know, man.
You're covered. Like, we can't even see you right now. You're covered in promos.
I needed a quick drink. I'm sorry.
That's right. All right, here we go.
Now we got the next loser side. We got Cosmos against Ray Ray.
Now they met in grand finals at Summer Jam, and Cosmos was able to take it. So,
but now they're really both meeting in loser side.
That's right. Yep. Ray is starting Sentinel here. He feels like it's just Magneto gives him a better chance in the anchor position.
I think it's more like he wants to put Sentinel first so that way he doesn't have to deal with it. If Magneto dies, he doesn't have to take all of this at the end game and guarantee his loss. I did say guarantee because Morgan destroys Sentinel.
That's right, yeah. Yep.
Yeah, there goes the rough work that I was mentioning right there.
I mean, again, really, on a team that predicates on being able to try and get in, Cosmos' team is just not going to allow him to do that.
Yeah, I also realized that Ray Ray's playing missiles assist.
Yes. Feels like it helps stop Morgan in the air with certain things.
Yeah.
But you got to be really careful with his calls because Doom can lose a lot of life real quickly.
Yeah. Good grab. Ray's taking it to the sky to try to stay safe. Wow, what a stalemate. Where they just stood still and didn't want to like approach the game so fast.
And Morgan's not got no bar. She just built her first bar.
Are we going to go into the... Yep, there it is. Ray is a little bit short before he reaches his bar.
Got to wait this out. Halfway done.
All right, so he's got one bar waiting for him now. Oh, he's sniping the assist.
Trying to snipe. Ooh, he's not going to burn it. He knew that the missile was coming. That the missile was coming. Very, very good awareness by Ray.
Oh, one drone hits. So much moving around. Who knows what's going to happen? Oh, man, the finger laser is trying to keep it still. Such neutral from these two players.
Ray knows. See, there we go. Cosmo got the bar. Yep.
And they're trying to not overcommit. They're all taking each other's turns.
Gonna spend it.
Dr. Doom might be going down due to the chip, though.
This is not looking good. Crossover counter.
And he got hit. One drain hit him, so he lost the bar, piece of the meter.
26 seconds left, and no one has died. Ray's doing a really great job.
Speaks too soon.
Yeah, really, really great job of just being able to survive on this team, which is really what you need. And now...
Morgan dies,
and now there's 21 seconds. Now Ray can finally move around. He can breathe now.
Oh, yeah.
He can call Sentinel.
Wow, he got him low.
There you go.
Oh, he wanted the grab. That was definitely the grab, but Sentinel's getting hurt.
Oh, this is scary. I don't know.
He needs to watch out for the assist calls. He's got to watch out for the assist calls.
Ray's got a very slim life lead. Oh.
That's why Ray needs to watch out for the assist calls, because if he punishes the assist. Oh!
Very, very nice.
Just to use the time to his advantage.
Yes.
He punished Virgil. Virgil's bleeding.
Both of them pop back.
6 seconds left on the clock.
6 seconds left.
Oh!
Very nice.
The retreat game.
To run away. Oh, gets
and
hit.
He got hit with the missiles just to stay in the game. Oh!
Oh, very nice.
Game one going to Ray Ray.
Wow. In a game with such quick matches, did you ever think that in 99 seconds only one character would have died?
Wow, that's what I'm saying.
That's pretty amazing. All right, here we go. Game two, Ray, again, just being very evasive here. Cosmo can't autopilot now. He really does have to try and snipe correctly.
Yeah. And it should be easier to keep Sentinel down seeing a body that big. But then again, I also feel like seeing how big Sentinel is, he gets to call his assist safely while just blocking the Sophist.
All right, yep. Got to bring him in. Throw. He'll take it all day. He's been playing Street Fighter V. Take the throw. All right,
there
we go.
Why did he have to take... Oh, wait, never mind. Yeah. I already understand now.
All right. Yep. Again, I like what Ray's doing here. Leave Cosmos with no meter. Just survive and hang on. And just keep on chipping out Morgan little bit by little bit. I mean, if you saw it in this other good, Morgan's already at half life just through chip alone.
Oh, man.
So Ray's basically saying, all right, you want to play a chip game? I'll play a chip game.
I like it. But the thing is, it's kind of rough because Sophist does so much damage for chip. And the fact that there's so many on the screen consistently just taking piece by piece by piece.
Oh, no.
Dr. Doom's going down to the chip.
That was a little bit too much of a hard read there by Ray.
And Sentinel has to come in with no... Oh, if he just said S. I I like the evasive maneuvers with Sentinel. The body's so big like that, avoiding everything.
All right, I mean, again, Grace just trying to get Chip in, trying to chip her out.
The X Factor just to make sure he can try to get it done.
Knowing fully well that he can't necessarily get a clean hit, so he's got to chip. Oh.
What else? Punish Ray for pushing a button, too.
Yeah, got hit in the mouth. Got hit in the mouth, as Jahi would say. Shout out to Jahi.
Put it in his mouth. He hit him right in the mouth. You got to say it with the F. Oh! Good blocks by Ray, but damn right, he caught him short in his legs. And Bird's just going to work.
Yep.
And the game's over, or is he gonna?
Game's over.
Yep.
Just like that.
1-1.
Cosmos ties it up.
Oh, just let you know, it's level grinding Cosmos. It's LVLG Cosmos.
That's right. Yeah, change the name on the tag. LVLG Cosmos. All
right. Round three. Good rocket punch by Ray Ray.
Yep.
Ooh.
Trying to use Sentinel normal to negate some of these fireballs, but winds up eating a.
Hyper force eliminating all the soul fist and punching the assist. Doom lost some health.
Oh, yeah.
There's blood on the screen. Oh.
Good, good. Wanting to slowly but surely chip Morgan out.
And also, good shots on the heavy by Sentinel just to eliminate the soul fist. This is coming in. Ray's taking some chip.
I'm loving this patient play by Ray.
I think the raw tag messed up Cosmos' chance to punish Magneto properly because the raw tag put him in a cross-up position. Oh man,
ooh.
Magneto's dying.
If he wants, yep.
Oh.
Wanted Magneto out. Wanted to get Doom there. That's why he X-Factored.
Oh, the ping pong.
Doom was able to fall out.
Look at the maze that Cosmos is creating for Ray Ray. Oh man, this is rough. Oh, good blocks.
Cosmos recognizing what Ray's game plan is now. And now just doing his best to avoid as much chip as possible.
And punishing Dr. Doom in the process.
Yep. Oh, this is looking bad right now.
Oh, Sentinel dies. He called the assist from down low.
No.
Oh,
just
man.
Foot dives right into the Soul Drain steal.
Yeah, I don't think there's any way Ray's coming back. He has no X Factor. There's going to be a lot of chip to take.
He's going to die to chip here.
Yeah, he's
all right, game three is going to go to Cosmos.
Yeah, by default, this is guaranteed.
All right, Ray needs to.
Yeah.
Ray needs to figure this out. Needs to get it going.
2-1, Cosmos. Go for broke.
Fight. All right.
All right. Oh, good overhead.
Ray's
but the drones.
Oh, gets
Ray's
the
waking hit. Up. He's got the save now. The drones got him in there.
Wants to snap in Virgil.
I don't know why he would want to do it. I would have killed Morgan. Morgan seems to be the problem.
Oh, very nice. Wanted to fall down with the button, Cosmos. You're light for your troubles.
Morgan, there it is.
He got a couple of hits on Virgil.
But even so, no, I felt like he should have killed Morgan. Morgan's what gave his team the problem. Virgil's always going to be Virgil, but like he should have believed in the incoming. Now he's got to deal with the,
very nice. Escapes the missile. And Morgan's going to go down now. All right.
Cosmos has to deal with the drone stuff. He's trying to find out openings and a way to get a bar. Now he can get Virgil in safety. Ooh. But the missiles calm down Virgil.
Oh my. This is a really scary situation. Ray does not want to get Virgil'd out.
He doesn't, but he got the
good
grab.
Scoop.
Wow, and he avoids the missile.
Good evasion. He's going to be able to squeeze.
No, he's not going to squeeze. He's going to spend two bars. Oh, never mind. I lied to you.
Very nice. And now Cosmo's got a block. Oh, good scoop.
Wow, and Ray is tying it up. Wow, what a clutch comeback.
We're going to go to the final game now.
Final game, 2-2. What a comeback from Ray Ray. Good stuff. Yo, is Ray Ray going to conquer the demon? Because Ray Ray's been taking a number of losses to Cosmos.
I mean, Ray has definitely beaten Cosmos before in tournament.
I know, but the climb count from Cosmos is so strong. Yeah. This is literally some hatred rivalry between these two.
Yeah. Ray is definitely going to have to... going to have to figure it out because he has to start Magneto. He cannot start Sentinel anymore.
Wait, he started Magneto this
he
fight?
He started Magneto for game four.
Oh, man.
He's got to find a way to keep Magneto healthy. Yep, waiting it out. Very, very yeah. nice. All right, now
can he cause assist now?
Yep. Cosmo's just sitting there. Sure, Bible knows that he doesn't have to engage.
There you go. Yep. He's got his missiles coming in now.
Shell kick, shell kick, fireball, shell kick, fireball, shell kick. Ray can't be too passive now. He's got to take risks here. Yep.
I like this.
Going back to his original game plan now. Going to try and sit back with Sentinel.
Just to stay afloat and safe.
Right. Does not mind if Sentinel dies, but also does want to see if he can get some chip on Morgan. Use those long limbs to try and just whittle her down little bit by little bit.
Oh man, Sentinel's losing health. Oh, he tried to be sneaky. He tried to be sneaky, but Jay Sentinel
was down. That was a little bit of an all-in there from Ray.
Nah, because he was backdashing to try to get same side hit, but Cosmos blocked just in time. I think he saw it.
A little bit of an all-in there.
Damn, and this is where Ray loses.
This is gonna be rough.
Dr. Doom left with no X Factor, while Cosmos has his full team, and by me full team, he has Morgan already put in all the way, and he still has X Factor and lingering.
This is going to be rough.
I don't want to say rough. I just want to say I can literally say this is impossible. This is literally impossible now. Yeah, this is it. Cosmos takes it 3-2 over Ray.
And Ray has been eliminated from the tournament. All right. So right now we have TG, This Is For Larry, who actually sent Cosmos into losers. Mm-hmm. And so this is the run back from the pools.
This is for fourth place. For those of you who don't know what I'm eating, I was eating some chips.
Let's run some promos.
All right,
shout outs to our good friends over at G Fuel again. Mm-hmm. The official energy drink of esports. A low calorie option to the sugary, diabetes causing, right? sugary drinks that are out there.
So these drinks are the type of drinks that will keep you awake.
That's right.
Prepared, hydrated,
If you're getting your CrossFit on, your P90X on, G Fuel will
is
be
the way to go,
controls.
Right?
All right. Use the code EZT for 40% off this weekend only. Also, shout outs to Vertigear, whose chairs that you see, one of the chairs that you see in front of you on stream.
Yeah, they're the sponsored chairs.
Detachable arms so that you can play with a stick or without a stick. Use the code ECT2016 to save 10%. The offer is valid until September 5th. And really comfortable chairs. You can lean back in them. Comes in all array of colors and forms. Yeah, and easy to assemble at home.
Oh, yeah.
Once again, is there a money-back guarantee on the chairs? We don't know.
We just know that thing. Right. It is what it is.
It is what it is. All right, here we go. So, this is for Larry versus LBL.
Oh, no, we have Winner's Finals going on instead. We have...
Oh, no.
We have Flux versus Punisher.
Yeah, so Cosmos is taking a break here. All right, this is Winner's Finals now. Flux versus ANBU, LBLG, PUNISHER.
We have Ambu and Level Grinding's Punisher against Flux. Flux on the player one side, Punisher on the player two side.
That's a lot of letters.
Right. A lot of letters.
That is almost in danger of hitting the Twitter character limit. All right, here we go. Who will come out on top? Let's see how Punisher can do keeping Zero out.
I mean, Punisher did pretty good because he put, even though he's eliminated from the tournament, but he did put Mac Never Drops into losers.
That lot, he's got tons of experience with the team. He fights his team all the time.
Yeah.
For Punisher, it's really about creating breathing space. Flux doing a good job avoiding the chip game, though.
Oh, yeah. I like he's trying to keep his distance from Zero to make sure Zero doesn't do anything. And he's He's living off the shield so that he doesn't get hit with Buster.
And Punisher is not playing Strider. He played Strider against Ray. He's switching over to Hawkeye because he recognizes that he wants to snipe out Zero more.
And he needs to keep a distance. Oh, but speaking of distance, Flux finds an opening, but MODOK's weird body and his head, even though his whole body is his head, just to drop out the combo. But Hawkeye coming in to save the day.
All right.
Wow, Flux completely avoiding the triple piercing.
Very, very solid play. Very great movement from Flux to avoid all the kind of arrow.
Wow, yep. The X-Factor.
Punisher knew that he did something unsafe, had the X-Factor.
Wow.
Just raw lightning cross-up.
And he got it.
Gonna watch his X-Factor go away.
Oh, he tried to reset.
Tried to reset.
What a whiff. Flux capitalizing off the punish on the whiff. Same side. Caught him in the forehead right where you analyze stuff.
Yep.
So much for the reach, right?
Well, the big body means that MODOK is going to get instant overheaded a lot.
Well, his brain power don't mean anything anymore.
Same
side
that's
again.
That's the meta, yep. That's the meta now. The meta is changing now. Just call Dante, stay on the same side as Zero.
Game one going to Flux. Fluxington. Oh, Punisher trying to stay safe, flying away from Zero. Dang, that is so short. Did you see?
Air dash down low. Very strong.
Very strong mix up in itself. And he had jam session keeping him there, so he didn't know what to expect.
Good block. Nice patience. He's got to get out of that corner, though. Very nice to stuff the jam session.
Ooh.
Did not want to have to take anything.
He's bringing in Raccoon to keep Hawkeye safe. Raccoon going underground. Oh, Gregory got punished. The same mix up again.
Makes the overhead. Goes low.
I felt like he should have assumed the lowest coming. Seeing that Raccoon's so small. I honestly don't know, the person saying. But it looked like it would have been really hard for Flux to get an overhead on Raccoon. So he should have expected the low.
Oh, very nice. Get the party started.
The whiff on the S.
A little bit too high. So Gendo.
I like that.
That's so Gendo, I'm sorry.
Just to keep him safe.
All right. Yep. Can he chip out?
Yep.
Very nice. All right. He's got a chance.
Oh, because he died in the player one.
Oh,
wow.
Cross up.
Wow. But yeah, Punisher tried to move in to get a good mix-up, but he was stuck because Zero's dead body. I think it's the player one glitch when he dies, you're stuck in place.
Oh, this is bad. Flux builds a bar. I think it's going to be really, really hard for Punisher. But gets a hit.
It's Punisher. I believe in Punisher. That's my brother from another mother, man. I believe in his no X-Factor coming, but...
Next hit wins.
But Flux does have X-Factor. Oh, no.
Got an X. Yep.
He didn't necessarily have to X. He could have took the hit. But I guess he didn't want to lose any more damage than he should have. I like the neutral and the keep away wars between the two players.
Oh!
Ooh.
Great grab. He's not going to be able to kill.
But this damage is serious. He is going to kill now. The comeback with no X Factor. Punisher! Wow!
Flux nodding his head.
That was clean.
The play.
That was actually clean. Good job, Punisher. Alright, but Flux is frustrated right now. He's trying to keep it close. MODOK's going down immediately in his eyes.
Yeah, Punisher not able to run away.
But I don't know, MODOK has a weird head. So as long as he doesn't drop this is good because yeah, he's dead. Good block.
Very, very
real good blocks by Punisher right there. Flux is trying to keep the pressure going. Oh, that was a good low. And there it is. What such pressure from Flux. Great play by...
Yeah, there's no reason for Zero not to stay in there.
Oh, yeah.
There's no reason for Zero. Punisher couldn't get away.
He hit him with the same mix-up again.
Yep. All right, game three.
Zero has too many mix-ups in itself.
Very convincing.
This game was very convincing. Wait, did this just get? Did anything happen? Is this a perfect? Damn! What letters?
What letters?
That hurts. Punisher taking a breath.
I wonder if Zero players though are like they don't really even feel any sense of pride with perfect. You know what I mean? It's just the kind of a thing that just happens with a lot of Zero teams.
Yeah. It does happen because he gets to do it himself. Once you get the mix up, yeah, they're just gonna hold it.
Yeah. With your team, when you get a perfect, I mean, it's like.
Oh, yeah, that's very entertaining. How does Scamper do it? The world will never know.
All right, here we go. Oh,
okay. The bugger.
Punisher able to get away, but then he wants to go in. I don't like that. I think he's got it.
Wow,
stay
what
away.
A block.
Oh!
Wow. Ooh. Forward H.
I'm sorry.
He's still got a ground bounce waiting for him.
I'm sorry for doubting you. It looks like Punisher did go back to Strider now. He wants to limit Zero's movement options.
Yeah.
Recognizing that Hawkeye is just not going to be able to get the play.
That move, that booger itself by MODOK is great. Wow. The booger is a mid up close, but when the booger hits the floor, it's a low. Such switch ups.
Solid play for Punisher right now. Fuck that Bay in a way, recognizing that he does not want Virgil to teleport behind him.
And then just jam session hits MODOK.
He's going to curse.
Oh yeah, he's going straight to X-Men to get rid of this big body bastard. Oh, because he was so short and whiff, but it didn't matter to Dante. Dante said, I got you, brother. It all comes down to Anchor Strider. Can't Punisher do it. Well, he doesn't have X-Factor no more, so he's fine. So Strider can live.
I think he's dead.
Nah, two bars, he can live. He can live.
Oh.
Oh, good snap back.
Oh, very nice. Oh, okay, here we go.
Oh. Good blocks on the
good
overhead.
Good block on the overhead by Flux.
Hit him with the same side thing, mix up again. The mix up in the mix up. Virgil coming in, X-Factor's running out for Strider.
Oh. Stuffs it.
Oh, almost a punish. You're going down. Damn it, X-Factor ran out for Punisher. I want to know what is Strider going to do.
This is going to be
actually really rough.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty hard.
And Flux has one more bar left.
One more set of swords. Yep, chooses to spend it. Right, he's going to be able to build another bar here.
Yeah, and the chip is coming
down.
Yeah,
there you go. Yep.
He's running down all that life. The chip is real.
Right, Punisher's just going to have to hold this right out. And now he gets to play. Here we go.
Oh man, this is rough. He's low on health. 20 seconds left on the clock.
Life lead, yep. Flux just looking for a snipe. The orbs, yep.
Oh! Full screen!
Oh no.
But he made the drop. But Flux still has no bar left. 10 seconds left on the clock.
This is going to be really, really interesting here. It's going to happen.
Oh!
Stop.
Punisher really needs to look for his opening. This is rough. 6 seconds left. Oh my god!
Oh!
Hellbreaker for the win! Good stuff by Flux.
Punisher now sent to losers.
Oh man, Flux is definitely waiting in grand finals. And now we have the run back from the pool play. Cosmos versus No Life. But anyway, I just need to get this quick stretch on. Do you need to wake up?
I'm good. I'm feeling pretty good. With my G Fuel. I'm feeling excellent right now.
That's exactly what I was aiming for. Gotta wake up with that G Fuel, man. They're the energy drink supporters to ECT right now.
The official energy drink of ECT.
That's the wake up call that we all need. Get 40%. Wait. What do they do?
Yeah.
What's up? Yeah, 40% off your order this weekend.
You get 40% off your order with code ECT at checkout. Thank you for supporting ECT, for making this event possible.
Oh, yeah. Code ECT, remember that. Oh man, stretch is good. Speaking of which, I could use a drink right now. As we talk about this next match, this run back is going to be good because, you know,
that's
Cosmos
right.
took a big loss. It wasn't even like, hey, it's 3. It was 3-1.
It was 3-1, that's right. This is for Larry. 3-1 Cosmos. No Life has been really stepping this game up this year.
Yeah.
Even in the last couple of months, top 8 finished at Summer Jam, and now top 8 finish here. Playing for third place right now, or third or fourth place. Fourth place.
Oh, man. All right, so we're going to get into it. Player one, level grinding Cosmos, LBOG, versus TG. This is for Larry.
The whole TG team is back in their boy. No Life is playing this for Larry because he wants to support his grandfather who is in the hospital right now. Again, all of our thoughts and prayers go with
But No Life is trying to keep the pressure. Oh, the missile stopped the movement. Oh, but we're backing up. Creating the space just to make sure you don't. Oh, the buster. Oh!
Gets the hit.
I'm not going to lie to you. With that mirror sister in the way, it is confusing me.
Gets the hit on, just goes meaty on incoming.
Going into swords to and he got the hit. What happened?
No.
Good attempt, good attempt, good attempt. I actually like the snapback, it didn't work out.
Dante's gonna go down out here.
Oh no. Zero stuck, can't really move. Good buster by No Life to punish the Doom Assist while he's there.
He's got to be a little bit more mobile here with Zero to avoid the fireball game.
But I think he's taking advantage of him charging buster and punishing Doom only. He doesn't want to just like, hey, I'm just doing things just like see if I can win the book. He's trying to punish Doom a lot more than, dang.
He's got to be able to be a little bit more evasive. Yep, no. Wanted to try and... A little bit too desperate right there.
And Virgil comes in with level 2 X Factor, and he took the overhead. Oh, but he's alive. You're going down. Oh my gosh. And there it goes. Good overhead from the toss up. Cosmos takes it on No Life.
It was a little bit passive there from No Life. A little bit passive. He should have been a little bit more active there with Virgil.
Yeah, if anything, I feel like after he did Swords, he should have applied more pressure.
Oh.
Wow. Cosmos and Sophist placements are actually on point. Every time he wanted to escape it. Oh, wow.
Goes all in. Bets it all on black and drops a combo.
Damn, that's something we don't want. He went all in, X factor, and did an S, and he dropped it. That was a drop that he didn't need. This is actually going to look pretty, pretty rough right now. And now that he has no more X Factor, which is Dante and Virgil left.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, he's definitely going to be leveling level 3 in this one. Well, actually,
no, he doesn't need to.
Kill it in 2 bars. Yep.
I feel like he should just switch. Just to keep. Wow.
Whoa.
Wow, No Life is getting a lot of stray hits.
Wow, Cosmos is just waking up with a lot of buttons right now.
Yeah, but...
He's getting hit for it.
Oh, good attempt.
Nice.
Oh, and a happy birthday.
Right into the happy birthday.
Cosmos is going up over No Life 2-0.
Acting up a little bit.
No Life taking a quick breather. Is that the new tech now where we just go to main menu just to relax? Oh, the voices. You know, that's something I need to work with too, because I'm not going to lie to you. I really hate Chris's Japanese voice. And I mean really hate. I really hate. Fire! I'm like, I want to hear that well, Americanized voice.
Well, and if you're used to practicing with a certain kind of a voice, you know, language.
Not me.
You know, it can affect your timing on certain things. If you're an audio, if you play by audio player, not everyone's an audio-based player. You know, some people will like play with headphones and play music and not. But if you're really counting on those sounds, sometimes it can mess with timing and things like that.
You're right, but me, I'm definitely fine with what I'm doing. I just want to hear him say "eat lead," and I can't hear that in Jap. So. Speaking of eating some lead, this man's taking some fists, some shell kicks. Oh man, we're taking bars, and he took missiles. Oh man. This robot is getting obliterated. And he called the assist from up close. Oh no, Virgil took some health. He is bleeding. And he brought him in to make sure he doesn't recover. And he like, oh man, this is not looking good for No Life. Dang, and Virgil's going down.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, that my X-Factor is going to keep him alive. Wow!
Oh my.
What a belief in the confirm. Wow!
Oh. Just does it from the heavens.
Shout out to Nike for just doing it. Shia LaBeouf, you too. Whoa, that would have been OD.
Good awareness.
It's gonna be rough. No Life has no X Factor once again.
Good awareness there. He's got to back up. Yep.
Yeah, because he has no bar, and even so, he's.
Did he get the hit? Yep. Very nice into the crazy dance.
Wow.
Messes up the combo though.
I didn't like that. He just threw away the game with that.
That's gonna be it. Oh no.
But shout outs to No Life for taking fourth place. He definitely did it for Larry.
Definitely did it for Larry. Absolutely.
Now we have losers finals.
Punisher
versus Cosmos. Do you want to run any ads beforehand?
Yeah.
All right, so we're definitely going to get some stuff going on.
All right.
So right now, we got Vertigear. The guys definitely helped this event with the chairs. Okay. Enter the promo code ECT2016 to save 10%. Remember, it's this weekend. Ends on September 5th.
All right. And while they're doing a button check, we got a little video to show you from our friends at Matcherino, crowdfunding your favorite events or players. Too much time? Oh, no website. Okay,
oh, it's just the website.
Just,
okay.
Right, just the website. Okay, sorry about that. Matcherino, crowdfunding your favorite events or players. Start a bounty today. On Matcherino, you can donate to prize pools, buy awesome rewards, register for tournaments, and even collect payouts, sort of like a Venmo and a PayPal for the FGC.
Yeah, give people something to fight for, man.
Yeah, go to matcherino.com now. Help contribute to the ECT campaign, which we have met for $5,000. But you know what? We could always use a little bit more prize pool money in there.
Yeah. Right? And there's also a way where you can add a dollar for free.
Absolutely. You can add $1 to the ECT prize pool for free if you go to Matcherino right now. Support L.I. Joe and all the fine work that he's been doing. All the TOs and the organizers that are here for this event, making ECT as hype as it always has been.
That's right. Just click donate and enter the promo code ECT.
All right. Looks like we're ready to go now. Right. Great friends playing each other, teammates.
Yep, both level grinding players.
Right, roommates.
Yeah, level grinding's Cosmos back on player one again. And this time, Ambu and level grinding's Punisher on player two.
That feeling when you're going to play a close friend whose game that you're very well aware of. I mean, just your whole mentality of the game just changes, you know? How you approach. The types of things that you do in neutral, not being too predictable. This is going to be serious.
Yeah, but that's going to be
I
hard.
See some great neutral right now.
That's going to be hard because they know each other's playstyle very well.
Yep.
I mean,
okay, Punisher going back to Hawkeye here.
I actually like that he plays Hawkeye because Hawkeye fights Morgan pretty well.
Once the arrow's in the sky, to sort of just snipe Morgan.
Oh, man. Ooh. What a confirm by Cosmos. Oh my gosh. The ping pong on MODOK just because he's big body.
Oh. Yeah, MODOK's going to go down here.
Yeah, Punisher wanted to snipe from up top, but he couldn't do it because he was way too high up on the screen.
All right. Oh. Willing to bet the farm on that swing. There we go. Oh, gets it. Oh,
whoa.
What a confirm. And this is the age. This is the air age. Oh, no.
But I think the chip might be coming.
Yeah. It's like, how's it? There we go. Yep.
Raccoon coming in.
He wanted the cross up. Brewing in the tunnel. Waiting to get out. Yep.
Wow. Just because it lasted that long, they eliminated both shots.
Yeah.
I like the neutral from both players. They're trying to not overcommit. They're trying to find the opening. And Cosmos found his opening, got rid of Raccoon. The Punisher has no more X Factor, and Hawkeye's going to have the hardest time of coming in.
Gotta take everything.
Oh!
Very good. Dash underneath.
And Cosmos takes game one. I like how this is what I feel like Moon should have started. Do you see how he's like how Punisher was flying at the beginning of the match? Just to get some good close range in and to avoid some crazy stuff at the start. Oh, nice happy feet, but it didn't pay off anymore. Cosmos is
just gotta eat all of that.
Yeah, MODOK went down. Hawkeye's coming in. Cosmos found his opening once again. Hawkeye's going down.
Oh, and stealing meter.
Yeah, the less meter he has, the harder it is for Raccoon to work.
Oh, just X-Factors. He realized he made a mistake with teleport. Oh. And Cosmos just runs into the mine?
Well, then again, he was trying to block it. It was just that Raccoon happened to dig underground right behind him for the cross-up.
Okay, that was pretty interesting. Oh,
wow, that arrow.
That's the thing about that assist. It causes a soft knockdown.
Oh, he did it just to see if he'll call in Virgil. And Cosmo said, I'm going to fly this way to make sure this don't happen. Wow, what a way to get hit. Oh, that sucks. Cosmos keeps it simple to make sure he doesn't drop.
Wow.
Oh! That's disrespectful. That's actually disrespectful. But Cosmos takes it 2-0. It's almost there, almost there. He's looking so... No, I'm sorry, it was too disrespectful. Shout out to G Fuel once again for waking us up.
Game three, here we go.
That's my new face now, the G Fuel symbol.
Game three.
Back into game three, ooh.
How is Punisher going to get away here?
This is kind of rough.
Switched over to Strider again.
And once again, he's getting opened up by these overheads.
I just don't know how this character is going to be able to do anything against the team.
I didn't think that was necessary. Same, he had low health. But hey, if he got it, he got it. Oh, good snapback. He wants to get rid of Virgil. Shot him in his face.
It really has been Virgil that's given him an issue.
Oh, he got him with the fake.
Oh, no, and he missed.
Oh.
He will get Morgan. Morgan will go down here.
No. Oh, he couldn't finish. What's going on? He's too many drops by Punisher.
Gil is dropping these combos.
Oh, he messed up. He got her killed.
Very nice.
Oh, no, that was definitely rough. But Punisher no longer has X Factor.
Yeah, he's still got to deal with Virgil.
Oh!
Crosses underneath.
He literally, yo, the plink's on point with Punisher.
Oh,
wow.
No. He's about up on the wall.
He said wall cling, and he said no.
I mean, and that's the thing when you're playing a relatively new character, which, I mean, Punisher's been playing Strider for a little bit of time, but like, not in a tournament setting, you know, not as often as you'd like, you're going to run into situations like this at the end. Small situational things.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be the hardest thing to punish right now. He has no X Factor. Cosmos has two characters with X Factor. He has no more bar. I like how he's staying safe in the trap, though. Punisher needs some bar. He got one bar to get the trap out. There we go. Now he can stay safely in there. Oh! And he got it just in time!
Alright, Boulder loops.
Oh, he messed up.
He messed it up.
Oh, really? The cross up?
And
this is how we lose?
Cosmos is
oh,
take
come
it.
On. And Cosmos takes it 3-0. Cosmos caught it all the way back up from loser's side in pools.
Yep.
All the way to grand finals, loser's all right.
Alright, so this is going to be a House of Chaos grand final rematch.
Flux versus Cosmos.
Flux did beat Cosmos in a couple of tournaments very recently.
He also did it in the Buffalo Wild Wings tournament.
The Buffalo Wild Wings tournament. Shout out to the Bum and the HOC.
You already know. What other ads do we have to add? There we go. Let's get to 8-Arc. You guys, you know you want a new stick. Those who want to learn stick, feel free to go to 8-Arc just to learn some new stuff, grab some new stuff. Yeah, they sell bags. They sell sticks. Remember, coupon code ECT2016 to save $10. They make drones and carbon products.
Yeah, we actually have a copy of the drone here. We can get that on the screen. So you can all see this beautiful stick right here.
Yeah.
Beautiful stick right here. Yeah.
You don't have to see Scammy. You know, just make sure you block his face.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
Yep. There we go. Follow it everywhere I go.
There we go. So pick
this
one
of these matters.
Up. Thanks for supporting ECT. Thanks for supporting this tournament. Thanks for supporting the FGC community.
Also, we also want to promote some news. You know, PvP Live. Can we get their video to play real quick one time?
All right.
There you go. That's the PvP stuff, man. Shout outs to you guys. They're always updating us with news, scores, and highlights, and everything esports. So if you guys happen to miss out any of the tournament's results, don't worry. They're always keeping you up to date.
PvP Live. That's right.
So just be sure, if you guys don't always have time to, you know, check out on the websites, just be sure to download their mobile app as well. They're always keeping you updated on everything. You don't miss out a thing.
Absolutely.
And they also have the videos on their apps and websites as well, right? So now you can, like, keep up with the hype.
It's all there. All right, here we go. Let's finish up their button check.
Yep. Now we got grand finals back at it again. The run back. LVOG's Cosmos on the loser side of grand finals versus Flux on the winner side. The superheroes are all here. Who will rise to the top? All right, here we go. Cosmos do got to win six games to win this entire. He's got to reset from Flux.
The fight is on. Go for
and here we go.
Cosmos has to win six games against Flux.
Just to win this entire major. Oh, man. I like how he's keeping the pressure and keeping Flux at bay so he doesn't have to, like... Oh, but Flux with the Hadangeki is trying to keep up with everything. Buster does piece out all the sofas a lot.
I'm really liking the movement here from Flux just to avoid these fireballs, not taking a ton of chip.
Oh, and the jam session catches Morgan. Oh, but he didn't have Buster fully charged his time. But it doesn't matter.
Very nice.
It doesn't matter at all.
Yeah, I feel like the difference between Flux's zero and a lot of other zeros against this matchup is really
good. Wow, good block.
Good block, but he came down with the button.
Yeah. But yeah, that is the difference. I agree with Flux's zero over other zeros. Like, he's well constructed, and he's not like he's just trying to go there. He's trying to be, like, secure with everything. And if everything else fails, he'll keep the pressure going until you burn what you have to burn to hit him.
Being really evasive there. Very nice.
Wow, good block. How did he know that was going to cross up?
Sometimes the game auto-blocks it for you. Sometimes you just guess.
Wow, well, he couldn't guess that rapid slash that hit him. Oh! Good stuff by Cosmos, and Virgil's going down.
It's just 50-50. Oh,
I lied to you. Oh no! The whiff on the S, and we're going into the level four. Virgil double trigger the three. Game one going to Cosmos. Psych, it went to Flux. My bad. I got mixed up on the Virgils. I saw two blue Virgils. They catch me off guard all the time.
The way that Flux is trying to win. Oh my gosh, the Buster. I was about to say, the way that Flux is playing the neutral so that he's winning the chip war against Morgan is very impressive.
Oh yeah.
Very impressive, but that didn't even really matter there because he just got a Buster.
Buster's what keeps Zero so secure. Like, any errors you make, let go of the button. Just let go of the button. You're always safe. Oh man, I want to know what's gonna happen now. Oh, and there goes the Buster again. See what I mean? Let go of the button whenever you feel insecure.
I feel like every time the Buster releases, like, release the Kraken. Like, yeah, that's just kind of deal. It's just like,
oh yeah.
Boom. All right, here we go.
And this is gonna be rough for Cosmos with Doom. I mean, he has done it before. Dr. Doom is pretty good, but Doom. Never mind. He still has a chance. Flux is dropping it.
I think he missed his air dash down.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's not what he wanted.
And Flux is now securing this with game point.
Wait, is this going to be a clean sweep?
Damn, clean sweep.
On our Summer Jam champion.
And this time, no excuses, man. No excuses. He said, I'm gonna destroy you. Didn't he 3-0 him last time at Bums Wild Wings tournament?
I don't know.
Well, regardless, there's a clean sweep for this major win for Flux. He's at game, set, and match point to secure this major win.
All right, Cosmos gets a little bit of breathing room finally, and keeps on falling into that Buster. I mean, Cosmos keeps on falling with the button, and Flux is aware of it.
I think he's getting desperate.
Yeah.
Wow, Zero took some damage.
For that Buster, for that drop. Oh.
And he burns the X-Factor to not get hit. Oh, he punished Dante, that's why.
Oh, misses flight.
Wow.
Banked it all in that mix-up.
Missed opportunity.
Nice. Oh,
and missiles are still coming in.
That would have been a great confirm.
Oh, and Flux with the staggered hits just to catch a push block or
good
patience by Cosmos.
Good block from Cosmos.
Ooh, and then Flux gets opened up. Ooh, we're taking a bar. And here we go.
Oh, this is going to be really hard.
Yeah, especially since Flux has no meter now. And Virgil went down.
It's going to be really, really hard.
Cosmos still has his full team. What is Dante going to do without X-Factor against a full team, especially with Morgan still going in? He's still got lightnings. Oh, but he got hit with missiles. He tried to cycle crush his way in there.
All right, we got to take it to the next game. Or no,
he
avoided
the missiles. Yes, he did. Oh, opened his head up. Wow. Yeah, this is a done deal. This is definitely done because Virgil's going to come in for the assist. Psych.
Yep.
All right, so it's 2-1. Still Flux's game. Flux is still at match point.
Flux wanted the teleport.
Yeah. Oh. Wow, good blocks by Cosmos. Yo, Flux, everything Flux does is so layered. And it's just so, wow, if he had that. Good fix. Oh, too many drops. Shadow Clone Jutsu holding it down.
Now Morgan can get established. So Getsu's gone for Flux.
Oh, good punish on Dante, saving him from getting hit with Jam Session.
Very smart.
Cosmos trying to keep it together. He's not trying to lose this major. Oh, he almost had the mix-up. The pressure.
Cosmos really trying to get that bar.
But he's not trying to, I like how he's not trying to overcommit because the first two games he was overcommitting.
But he gets the Soul Drain now he can get established. Gonna be bad for Flux.
Is Zero gonna die? Oh, and then the Soul Drain saved him again. What is he punishing?
That was great evasion from Flux right there.
Wow, the level 2 Buster chipped him out. Foot dive, shutting down Dante. Oh, Cosmos gotta watch out with his assist call. Oh man. Wow! Even though he got the trade, he managed to stop. Wow! The raw S. Virgil's going down. No meter. Wow!
What is happening right now?
Oh
my God!
Oh! And that's it. Cosmos ties it up 2-2. Cosmos
gonna
is not.
Have a record reset here.
Oh yeah, he's not going down without a fight. Cosmos is one away from the reset. Flux is one away from winning this major. The concentration. Oh, man. Dang, and Cosmos is opening him up again.
Oh.
The buster. Little but he's got the soap fist hitting him from behind. Cosmos finding his way out of there, avoiding the jam session. Oh, and he got him opened up from the dash.
My goodness.
Virgil's going to come in, have to take
is
all this.
Cosmos going to reset after being down
2-0. Wow. That's Soulfist, he didn't care. Oh no, but Flux teleport right into everything else.
Yeah. It works Sentinel to negate the fireball.
Yeah.
Spencer's get over here can negate the fireball.
Oh, I didn't know about that. Wow, Cosmos caught him from the other side.
Yeah. Oh, and
oh my gosh, stealing meat. Dang, he stole the entire bar. Flux is in here with no meter whatsoever, but he still has X-Factor waiting.
Leaving
all he needs is one
zero.
Clean hit.
Leaving it with zero.
This is actually rough. Flux just want to go home now. He doesn't want to keep playing. He wants to win. Oh.
Wow.
He's banking it all. And then there it is. And we got the reset.
Oh, both of them are in the loser's bracket now.
Wow. I like how Cosmos kept his composure. Kept it.
Gilbert
three
just
straight.
Watching in the back going,
right
that should have been me.
Went right back
that
into it.
That should have been me. Punisher.
No. We went right back into it and he got opened up already. Is this how we start the reset?
Yeah. Well, Flux did win the first two games.
Yeah, he did. Oh, no. Oh,
that one
that
did cross
up.
That one did cross up. Very nice. Very nice.
Electrifying robot.
Sports entertainment. Very nice. I'm on that Shinsuke Nakamura right now. NXT. Alright, here we go.
I like Humbreaker. Oh, he did super. He tried to like gambling.
He tried to dimension slap super, try to get the cross up.
Well, Flux making a statement with this perfect.
Flux keeping it meeting.
A clean perfect.
Game one.
This is how we started after the reset, yeah.
Flux. Game one.
Ah, that hurts. That hurts the soul. When you see the golden letters, that hurts the soul, man.
Oh.
Flux is trying to get in there. Not trying to take any at least any time. Trying to not lose his chances.
Oh,
the fist.
Yep. Cosmos in a lot more control here.
The raw tag on Virgil. He just didn't want to lose Zero. Zero definitely has a chance to. Zero does fight Morgan very well, right? Well, he fights everybody very well. He's Zero.
Yeah. Cosmos does not like Zero. Cosmos makes the argument, which I don't agree with, that Zero is way better than Morgan. And I personally don't agree because, I mean, look at what you're seeing right now.
I honestly feel that the match is even between Morgan and Zero. It's got to be 5-5.
I'd say it's more of like a 6.5, 3.5 Morgan's favor. I'm not as willing to go as far as say 7-3.
But either way, Flux loses Virgil. The X Factor is to save Zero, but Zero might be going down. Oh, wow! A stray standing medium!
Oh.
And now here goes Morgan. This is going to be rough because Cosmo's got to take all these incomes now.
Oh!
Another hit. Oh!
Flips
no.
Him. Cross up.
Cosmos still got the X-Factor.
Cosmos, yep.
Into the head.
Really able to prevent Flux from really even pressing anything.
Yep. And it's 1-1. Cosmos and Flux has tied it up. They're trying. This is a fight to the death. Oh my gosh. I love this game. Even with the characters I hate seeing, I love this game.
Oh.
The pressure and the escape plan by Cosmos. Good flyaway.
There you go.
Oh man. Flux is having a hard time getting in and he just got opened up with.
Fake out lightning. Yep.
Yeah. Drain hits the assist. Flush can't afford to lose no meter. Bridges comes in, just taking this. Oh man. Yo, that judgment cut is so huge. I never expected to be as, now that I pay attention to it, because I guess when I play against it, it doesn't seem so huge, but now watching it, that is
really huge special move in Devil Trigger.
Oh yeah.
Wow, what a way to get fisted in the face.
Want to get rapid slash, but then that's just getting so. Oh,
wow.
Let's get it started now.
That was a birthday he needed, though. I mean, it sucks that Doom dropped out, but that was
Release
a birthday he could have.
The Kraken.
Oh. Good block. Oh, he caught him air dashing. No escape. What's the incoming setup? I'm nervous about this because Dante could. I mean, Dante. Virgil. Oh, he just did super and he caught Flux. Oh, no. Oh, he tried to punish Dante 100%. Wow, that was scary. That was very scary. Cosmos is taking the lead 2-1 over Flux. Wow, and he was literally coming.
About to bring back Punisher is just in the back laughing his head off.
Yeah. Oh, but Flux is up to a great start. Catching Cosmos with a buster.
Oh, Flux coming in the background with a vengeance.
Yeah, he's wasting no time now. Just immediately, I'm putting an end to this man right now.
I just feel like we're watching just a Jedi lightsaber battle, just two heavyweights going at each other. taking an advantage off. Oh,
wow. Because he caught the push block.
The push block. Nice
Footsies.
Stagger. Nice stagger.
Oh, man, this is scary. Bridges got to come in and take this. Flux said, I'm not going to lose this major, yo. I want this major. Bridges got to come in and take this.
Very good block.
And, wow, good grab. And here's the perfect once again. Another perfect? Both Flux's wins in this reset are perfect?
Again, I feel like a zero perfect is kind of like on a different level than like the other perfects that we see in this game.
Yeah, you're right. But dang, yo, like, now it's 2-2 with both Flux's wins only being perfects. Yo, if Flux wins this major with all three of his W's being perfects, I'm gonna laugh.
Well, that's definitely not gonna happen now.
Yeah, because he definitely got missile and Cosmos is ready to go
to win. Cosmos just does not want this character living.
Wow, that's not what we do. Oh my god. He says he really hates Zero, but he just gave him the opportunity with the. Oh man, that's a drop combo you can't afford, man.
Flux burns his X-Factor too.
Yeah, the desperation to keep Zero alive. Oh, what happened?
No. All right, now.
What happened there? Did he just, like, let go of Buster?
Flux, not like this, buddy.
Well, both characters are just fighting with strict neutral now and set plays. Wow! What a confirm of the round trip.
Flux is feeling
himself.
Oh, right now.
This is not good. This is definitely wrong.
He's doing the Flux head bob. He's feeling
and he has to grab and to confirm. Jam session.
Very nice.
Oh.
Very nice.
Oh! That was ridiculous. Stop, Flux. Stop.
Flux is going in right now.
Yeah, he's going ham.
Oh, my gosh.
He's caught the punish on I don't know what that was. I think it was a foot dive.
I ain't going home until you
make me
go home.
I mean, he wanted the foot dive.
I am not going home until you make me go home.
Yeah, the concentration on their faces is real right now.
Oh.
Ah.
Flux has no bar now.
No bar.
He's got to be really careful. Ooh. See, I would like Cosmos to have saved this last
bar. Oh, what was that? Hey, Cosmos is keeping it clean. He's coming back. Oh, and he took the bar.
Does he got it? Does he got it?
Yeah, he's got the infinite from right there. He's got this.
Very nice.
That was so clean. Cosmos is pulling comebacks.
Give him two bars now. Gonna give him two bars. Bring in Virgil. Yep.
Yep. Virgil with full health. Dante is all that Flux got left.
He's got two rounds of swords to block.
He needs to make this tournament count. Oh my gosh. Flux could be going home. Second place.
Very good blocks. Oh, very good stuff. Very good awareness by Flux.
Flux does have one bar.
He's gotta be super careful now.
Oh! Double trigger.
Yep. Once double trigger, wants to snipe out Doom. Objective one.
Oh! Oh! He got opened up.
I think that's.
No, he's still alive. He's alive. He's alive. He's not
really
dead.
Really
But he's got the bar back again, so he can double trigger to get the life back up. Good break by Cosmos. Oh! Good grab. Good game by Cosmos. Takes it.
Is your ECT 2016 champion.
With a pop-up like that, he did come back. Yeah, I appreciate the pop of that, but Flux gave him the respect. But if I was in Flux's spot, I would have pulled his pants. Are they? Oh, let's go. That's it. Pants him on screen. But anyways, enough about me talking. Enough about my face. Let's end this tournament with... No. We're going to keep it in this order. Let's promote this stick. Since you want to do this, you got this, Jason. You can promote this.
All right.
as we put this to a close.
As we sign off, guys, I just want to let you know, Marvel is as strong as it's ever been. And the players that are coming out to these tournaments right now are showing the highest level of tech. The game is still evolving. We need you guys out here at these events. We need you guys supporting it. Marvel is definitely not dead. And we hope to see you guys all next time. So signing off here, this is JSONG, DCB JSONG.
And this is PAG Scambi. Right. See y'all next time. Follow us on Twitter, man. At Scambi820.
And JSONG27. All right. Take care. We're out. See ya.
Throw on a headset there and tell us how you're feeling.
Hey guys, what's good? This is Cosmos. I can't even believe what I just did, to be honest. I'm absolutely astounded. That was the most intense set I've ever played in my life. In Grand Finals against the ZMC specifically.
I still want to say you're whack.
To be honest, I really thought I was done after the first set. But after he was up 2-0 on me and I was in losers and he was in winners, I thought it was over. And I just said, you know what? Screw it. Don't give up. Just keep on fighting. And thank God, man, I won. I did it for all of y'all.
shout outs to Coach Steve for him to, like, you know, give out such promotional lines for other people to take.
Definitely one of the best sets I've ever played in my entire life. I really enjoyed that. Win or lose, I would not have been salty in the slightest bit, because that was incredible on both of our parts.
Yeah.
That.
Shout-outs to No Life. For
yeah, shout-outs to No Life. To. Yeah. Shout-outs to No Life for actually putting me in losers.
Yeah. Shout-outs to Flux for all the stuff that he did, so.
Hold up, pop. Let me just.
All right, but that's much love to Cosmos for the work he put in. We got Flux jumping on the mic. He's like, I didn't want the second place.
Oh, damn it.
What happened, Flux?
I got this stupid medal around my neck. What is this?
I want to talk about like, how did that come to happen, knowing that you had the 2-0 lead on the first set of the grand finals?
Yeah, it was. I definitely had one game in the first set, which was kind of an oops by the S, because it crossed up, and I was like, oh, shh. I was like, oh, no, not like this, but it wasn't exactly like that. But honestly, the set was really, really good, and I feel like we both played, like, pretty well. Yeah. So it was, I'm okay, like, I lost, whatever, but I got my rocks off with Virgil in the last game, so I don't really care that much, like, that was kind of sick.
Nah, but after the reset, what me and Jason was watching, I mean, yeah. both your perfect wins, yeah, from what we saw two different mix-ups in both different sets. Well, I mean, there were mix-ups that was just, wow.
It's just shit, man.
I know that, but it was just that the incomings that you did with Zero was very different every time, and the way
that's
it was
how,
different.
That's how, like, I've got, like, classifications of mix-ups with Zero that I do, like, so I just try to keep it fresh.
Yeah, and I was always questioning. I was like, how much more mix-ups can Zero have? Like, these are some different size, same size stuff. I'm like, oh, gosh.
He's got a lot of nonsense. Like, I did a mix-up I almost never do. I did cross-up medium dive kick.
Yeah, that's bull. That's what I was looking at.
Totally,
I was like,
totally bullshit, but, like.
That's what I was saying. Yeah, I was like, was that same side or was that cross-up?
Once,
I was like,
once
no,
the
we
set,
saw that.
Once the set gets that far, like, we played that many games, you really got to go to, like, the real treasure box, like, this, yeah. All the bull crap, like, all the crap that you come up with in lab, and you're just like, oh, this is good, I'm gonna use this someday, but it requires a certain level of, like, you gotta train people to react a certain way on defense, but that was a sick set, I'm really happy, actually.
Nah, it was
really,
really good.
Even though I didn't lose, I'm really happy.
I did tell Jay Song that if you was to beat Cosmos after the reset with all three of your games being perfect, I would have left.
That would have been ham. Yeah. That would have been nuts. That was 3-2 triple perfect. Hey.
Because it was good. I was like, wow, he got
and
two.
And you know
perfects.
The thing was, at Summer Jam, I like kind of played like shit in top eight. So I'm glad that I got to play well today at least.
Yeah, you did
like,
really
I,
good.
I played well, and Cosmos won that tournament too. And I was tight because I didn't get to play him, and I felt like I could beat him. But you know, he got the best of me today. He was a good set.
And
really
we did speak about last time.
He beat everybody today, so I can't even talk shit.
He only lost to No Life.
Only lost to No Life.
He played the same team you did, but No Life gave him the work.
Different day, that matters.
Yeah, you're right.
Different day matters a lot. Yeah, so thank you guys. Shout-outs to everyone in New York. Shout-outs to the anime scene. Like, I heard them rooting for me while I was playing.
Oh, yeah.
That was kind of sick. Shout-outs to all the stream monsters. Hope you guys enjoyed the set.
Everybody enjoyed the hype. They saw some stuff they didn't expect to see.
Congratulations to Cosmos again. He played really great. Shout out to everybody I played. Shout out to Punisher. He played really well today. I actually was really happy with my set with Punisher, too. I thought it was really, really good.
When he switched to Strider.
I actually thought he should have stayed with Hawkeye.
That's what.
But he made the decision he thought he had to make.
I mean, I kind of like that he put the Strider, but it just didn't work out for him.
Yeah, because we were playing casuals on the side, and he was playing Hawkeye, and he was doing well with it. So I think he decided to make that switch. But, you know, it was really good. I'm really happy. I'm going to go enjoy Street Fighter now. Enjoy Guilty Gear, actually. I think it's about to start.
Well,
so, thank you. Thank you for commentating.
No problem.
Thank Shock. Thank everybody at Combat Network for streaming.
And thank you, Stream, for tuning in and showing love to your favorite players, man.
That was Marvel 3. Later, guys.
All right, now. I think we're going to go into KI now, right?
Yeah, we're going to have a couple minutes before KI. We got to get an Xbox set up, round up the players, and then 2:30, we should be starting KI top 8.
All right, no problem.
All right.
So since we're doing on this standby thing, after Cosmos says a few more words, do you want us to run some more ads and then?
We'll see what's up. Go ahead and say your piece.
Yes. Shout outs to Quackbot. Oh, shout outs to Quackbot. Nah, number one shout outs goes to my sponsor, LVLG. Honestly, without him, I wouldn't have been here, and I wouldn't have been at Summer Jam. So I am very grateful and thankful that he was willing to sponsor me. And I'm happy right now.
And you know what's the best part about this? I just realized last year's ECT, you got third place.
Yeah, I did. I lost the Flux at ECT.
Losing the Flux, yeah.
Yep. That's crazy.
No, and Ray Ray eliminated you.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
What a climb.
Good games.
That was actually – and now you, and the fact that you have to face him in grand finals and you brought it back, like, you took his spot. Because Flux won ECT last year.
Yes, he did.
Good stuff.
Yes.
Well, yeah. I'm glad you put out the shout-outs. I'm glad you put in the work. And I'm glad the FTSE Games was strong. I like how you did your – you did your moments, and you try to follow with him. I don't know how you did it, but there was this one backdash I saw you where he was really low to the ground. You backdashed with Virgil and got a crouching light, same side mix-up. Because when he tried
Virgil's is BS. That's why. Virgil's BS. On incoming, he's BS.
Yeah, but it was really, really good. And when I mean it was really good, it was really good.
Thank you.
I've never seen something like that. And then the pressure that you had with Morgan, there was sometimes you were slipping up. And
yes, of course.
Openings, and I was like, How are you getting opened up? I want you to tell us what you felt your mistakes were that Zero was always catching you.
My mistakes mainly, I'm not gonna use this as an OS.
No, that's not an OS. We just want to know the honest mistakes.
I know, and I've known that my pad is messed up. I'm not using that as an OS at all. But that is mainly the reason why he opened me up, besides moments where, of course, he hit me with his mix-ups. It would be times where I would try to soul fist and I wouldn't get a fly or an unfly. And I would get screwed over mainly because of that. Besides the times he would hit me with the mix-ups, of course.
But those times, you know, I told you when I used your pad, I like your pad just fine, and I enjoyed using.
You don't play heavy execution characters like I do.
Yeah, exactly. And the fact that, at least to me, since it had it so loose, I got most of my stuff to happen. Like, I'll get my command grabs faster, but mine is pretty stiff. So, if you want, we could trade pads.
I might be down with that. Oh yeah, we was talking about that yesterday.
Yeah. My buttons are everything is great and it's fresh, so you can do anything. I'm glad you did your shout outs and all that. Right now,
this man right here. Come on.
Yeah. Your sponsor's about to come in, show some love. After you, I also want to get third place.
This
in
man
because
right here,
third place.
This lovely man, this lovely gentleman right here sponsored me for this and Summer Jam. If it was not for him, I wouldn't have been here.
Yeah. Well,
biggest shout out.
I'm glad you and Flux show love. I also want to get third place in here, Punisher, because he got a medal himself.
Of course. So that's my teammate as well. Both of us are sponsored by LVLG.
Good stuff. That's also my brother from another mother. He's the man that taught me the game. My very first friend. Like, literally, he taught me the game.
Really?
And I don't mean like, hey, my combos or me doing things. He taught me everything. From me not having neutral, for me to have neutral. Look at this man right now. Look at him flexing with that medal. But, yeah, I definitely want to know what was his intakes and his mistakes, because he had to play both you and Flux, and he lost to both of you guys.
I'm curious to hear that as well, to be honest.
But thanks for the shout-outs and thanks for the words.
Oh, no problem. Thank you, guys.
All right, so we got Punisher joining me. My brother from another mother, man. How you been, man? You know I love you, right?
I love you too, brother. How's it going?
Pretty good. For those who don't know, I mean, I do love this man, but he's also my son's godfather. Yeah, shout outs to Noah and baby mom's Lily. So, you know, but it's much love. But yeah, like, I want you to know, Noah did say his first words, and his first word is hello. Not even daddy or mom, his first word is hello. I mean, I wish I was there, and I wish you were there to see it, but yeah.
Nice.
But I'm glad we had real life stuff. You're my man. Love you and all that. But let's get into your moments of what happened with winners and losers finals. First, let's go with you and Flux, because we saw you start off with Hawkeye.
Yeah.
And you did pretty okay, but you got opened up a few times, and then you made the switch with Strider. What made you feel that Strider was going to do the better decision with Hawkeye?
Okay, so one of the things that I noticed was that I was not getting the best out of the Hawkeye assist. So what I wanted to do was counter call jam session when he was when I wanted to approach him, right? Because if I call Strider, Strider can get sniped. But Aros will never get sniped because it will be Buster and whatever that comes behind it.
Okay.
But I was not calling it right. That was the first thing. Another thing is it has way too many dead spots where it's not going to hit Zero, while Strider actually tracks him down no matter where he is on the screen.
So if you felt that Flux was going to do a mix-up and then Jam Session was being the way, Strider would still follow Zero and hit him to, like, just at least praying for a hit so that you'll be all right.
Not in that case, because in that situation, then Jam Session can actually stop Strider if he's coming down, and Zero can just teleport.
Yeah, all right. That makes good sense.
But, yeah, I would say that I played, like, very sloppily when it comes to winners. I dropped a lot of things. And when I played against Cosmos, I dropped a lot of things, too. Like, you know, I wanted to do a snap when I got a wall clinch with Strider. That's what I want. I want to snap and then set up an incoming on Virgil because I knew I was not going to do anything.
But you felt that you were moving too fast? Or?
Yeah, I think I moved too fast and my hands were, like, way too cold. So that's another thing that actually hindered me a lot. But, you know, overall, the thing that actually affected me the most was I played really bad.
Right.
I dropped too many things. But, yeah, Grand Finals was actually really hyped. You know, I laughed too many times.
There was a lot of stuff that it was amazing play, like that. You're just like, wow, that worked.
Yeah, especially when Cosmos did a jumping ass with Virgil. And he stood in front of me. He slapped him in the face like, I'm here, wake up. It was funny because I think that Phlox actually thought that he was going to cross him up.
Yeah.
But it was just mind games right there.
Nah, but it was such good words, good analysis from you. From you realized what your mistakes were.
Yeah,
it's great seeing you, man. You know, it's
nice
much love.
Nice seeing you again too, man.
Definitely.
Feels good to actually come out to the sea more often. And yeah.
Shout out to your sponsors, Level Grind, and shout out to Play All Gaming for always.
First of all, I would like to
show me love.
Yeah. Shout out to the MK Network for actually having the stream. This is actually very awesome.
Yeah, these guys showed love to Marvelous. I mean, like, they just wanted to be here to help out in any way that they can, and they helped out with the top 8.
Yeah, a huge shout-out to Anbu for actually helping me out, supporting me all this time. To my boys from Hitbox, Dustin, and his brother, Sean Hoffer. Those guys are amazing. And, of course, Level Grinding for actually bringing me here and always being very supportive in terms of my tournament play and everything else.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, guys. You guys rock. You are the best.
All right. So once again, we're going to go to top 8 in KI. So we will have different commentators support you guys. So I will be getting up. Thanks for the words, Punisher, once again.
Yep.
Love you guys.
Thanks for having me. And
Marvel
guys,
Stream, we love you guys.
For watching.
And now enjoy KI top 8.
Definitely. Later.